Critics are urging the FDA to block.
And there we are. We are live. Welcome, everybody. Tony Katz tonight. Great to be with all of you. 800-571-9422 is the number. Anything Oscars is more than welcome this evening. We have a lot to get to. Also, a whole conversation about leadership regarding Ukraine. I don't get angry when people call it the Ukraine. The Ukraine. You know, it doesn't bother me. I don't think it's the right way to do it. So I will go correct and call it, you know, just Ukraine. A whole conversation about leadership. Paige is all crazy about the Oscars and John Travolta. So expect much from that. And that's the story. So it's going to be a great show. I'm looking forward to it and glad you're here. And just do the last-minute checking. Independence, breaking through the clutter with a different. And Paige, I know you got that email today about CPAC, but I'm not going. So.
Yeah, I just deleted it. Affairs. Because I'm obviously not going.
Well.
Nonsense.
It was Matt Welch. It wasn't for Independence. Lack of trying.
Hey there, it's Steve Simpson, and if you're like me, you
wasn't for a lack of trying.
Kind of like, look, if you make it a great spring, I promise to take more walks, to visit the parks more often, to really enjoy the outdoors. Now, if you notice, I promise to climb my ladder and make sure my gutters are clean. That is not high on your list of things you want to do, right? So, why do it? My friends at LeafGuard could not agree more. In fact, they have authorized me to give you Indy's only one-piece seamless gutter protection system on the market, installed on your home for only 99 cents labor. How's that for a spring promise? Here's the number to call, 623-8612, 623-8612. Tell them you want Steve.
There's a link on WIBC, which celebrities have the best-looking body in a bikini.
Chip, peel, or crack for only 99 cents labor. Go to LeafGuard.com now and give them a call for Steve's spring promise. Again,
I know that was a WIBC kind of thing, but you learn something new every day.
612.
Learn something new every day.
I'm Alex Brown in the 93 WIBC 24-hour news center. 36-year-old Timothy Guilfoy, then a teacher at Greenwood High School, faces preliminary charges of child seduction.
So
Metro
sick.
Police say he admitted to officers that he had been having sex with the underage female in his truck in the 8800 block of South Madison Avenue Saturday, and those officers say he was completely nude. Greenwood Community Schools confirms to 93 WIBC that Guilfoy has resigned. House Speaker Brian Bosma says opponents of the state's ban on same-sex marriage offered someone campaign money to challenge him in a primary, but two Republican party
that,
officials
to me,
say
is
that's
the most
the
unique
first
story in Indiana right now.
Bosma says he was offered unlimited campaign money if he killed H.J.R. 3. He also says opponents of the amendment offered to help fund a primary challenger, whom Bosma would not name.
This has been most unusual and completely out of line on this issue from the start, really only from one side throughout this year.
If that's true, Marion County Republican Party Chairman Kyle Walker hadn't heard of it.
I haven't had any conversations with anyone regarding a challenge to Speaker Bosma.
Neither had Peter Amy, chairman of Hamilton County's GOP. Bosma is unopposed for both the primary and general elections. Ray Steele, 93 WIBC
News.
Good
to see everybody.
19-year-old Nick Gepper of Lawrenceburg has received the Distinguished Hoosier Award from Governor Pence.
When I come back home skiing in southeastern Indiana, I have more fun skiing there than almost anywhere in the world because it's like hometown, stomping grounds, and I can get so many laps in because there's like never really any crowds, and the park is so awesome.
Gepper won the bronze medal in slopestyle skiing at the Sochi Olympics. You're up to date. Get local news on demand at WIBC.com. Now here's the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
An additional one to possibly three.
We're
ready. Something I'm going to do before I let you in.
We're not
sure.
Done yet. Temperatures
I am not surprised.
Hovering around 20, drop into the single
your show, your day.
As the snowfall.
But thank you.
Paid show, hot late show, hot show, paid show.
I'm RTV6 meteorologist Kevin Gregory.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Tony Katz Tonight.
Just kidding, the computer wasn't working right.
All right.
You are in.
All right. Great to be with all of you. Tony Katz tonight. 317-239-9393. Toll free 800-571-9422. The Oscars last night. Paige is just She's over the moon with John Travolta.
You don't even know.
She texted me earlier, here's your Travolta name. Now, it's Idina Menzel, right? That's how you pronounce
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
The chick from Wicked, who's the voice
Rent.
Behind the... And Rent. Yeah, you know, the problem with Rent, great music. It's the worst story in the history of mankind.
Oh, yeah. Well, but it's based off of...
No, it's not based off of anything.
La Boheme.
Yeah, I understand it's based off of La Boheme, but it's still horrific. When you can break a musical and say, oh, sorry, AZT time, which is a drug used to combat AIDS.
Right.
HIV. I'm sorry. The story is wretched. The music is incredible. Well, we'll get to that. But she'll have all of your Oscar stuff for you. Paige is Oscar's girl today, and she's super excited about it. This is new. I didn't know that Paige had this side of her. We'll be talking about that. We will be getting also a really interesting story out of Indiana. I think it's an intrigue story, and I think someone's making it up. Did somebody actually, was somebody willing to give Speaker Bosma payola to drop HJR3? To me, it's the most stunning story. It's like, it's happening in Indiana, but it could be happening right in Washington, D.C. It's directly out of House of Cards. That's how crazy the story is. I will get into all of that, and glad to see that the weather was not as bad as was predicted with the snow and the roads being, for the most part, clear based on everything we're seeing. Very happy about that. A conversation, if you will, because Ukraine, has been, of course, in the news, and it's been President Obama's total lack of focus on the conversation. Not that there is specifically something militarily that can be done or should be done, that America should not act and does not need to act as the world's policeman. That is not the reason I bring it up. I bring it up because there is a conversation about leadership that has to happen. And it's a conversation I keep hearing and keep seeing from progressives about the strong leadership of this administration. I have seen this now for years in different variations and in different ways. That stops today. It stops. We're not going to be the people, regardless of where you fall on the political spectrum, who engage the idea that President Obama is a strong leader. That's over, ladies and gentlemen. You don't get that one. It's gone. Don't bring it. I mean, you can try, but something will be handed to you that once was a part of you. You no longer get to bring that to the conversation. And it's a problem. You see, I can accept the fact that I do not share the ideas and values of President Obama. I can also accept the fact that I'm very thankful for that fact. If I accepted the ideas and values of President Obama, first I would accept very bad ideas like Obamacare and Dodd-Frank. And then I would accept values that aren't actually values, but are nothing more than political missives to move forward an agenda piece for a moment. They're not long-standing values. The long-standing values are part of what you see in terms of policy, which are things that I vehemently oppose, because if I agreed with those policies, I would be saying that I agree that a group of individuals knows better for my life than I know for my life. I'm very thankful that I can see past that. Very important. It's something that I am thrilled by every single day. But when we take a look at what's going on in Ukraine and take a look at President Obama's position on it, and you can relate it to other positions, you take a look at the fact that he gives this stern warning. The man is the king of the stern warning, ladies and gentlemen. He gives the stern warning to Russia that, you know, don't you invade Ukraine. And then you have Jay Carney, and he used some kind of weird, we'll know if the line has been crossed kind of talk. But what's that line? Hey, who said line? Well, you said line, Jay Carney. I don't mean line. I mean a line, not like a line. They're just talking. There is nothing behind the words, because there is no great thought behind the word, because there is no value system behind the words.
When you see him, though, make these ultimatums, you're seeing a lot of ultimatums lately, ladies and gentlemen. You see him make this ultimatum, and then you see the next day that he doesn't attend the national security briefing. He may have gotten, he may have received a national security briefing, but he did not attend the national security briefing. He left the chair empty. It's another occasion of the empty chair. The empty chair, the empty suit, the empty promises. In 2014, let's empty the Senate. That's my tagline right there. I'm going to put it on a t-shirt. But when you don't attend the national security briefing, you're saying something to the world. You might not think you're saying something to the world, but clearly, forget the world. Let's talk about what you're saying to America. It's not that big a deal. What's happening in Ukraine? Not that big a deal. That the people, they do not want to side with the Russians. They much more want to side with the Europeans. They are absolutely desiring freedom and liberty. They do not want the current president, because that is a guy who is clearly using the presidency to his own advantage, to his own financial advantage, and aligning himself with the Russians in hopes of getting certain financial favors, which also haven't come. So it's clear, at least to me, to one guy out there, and I think to you, that the lack of leadership from Obama, the lack of leadership in a conversation about what it is that America believes for the world, has allowed for opportunities when people do yearn to be free, they quickly realize they have no friend. That is new. We saw it in Iran, when it would have been so simple for President Obama to simply put on the green tie and say, listen, we believe in the rights of people to live their lives free of oppression, and we support them in every possible way that we can. No, it doesn't mean that we send our troops here, there, and everywhere. But it means they should know that when they're victorious, they'll have a friend in the United States of America. Simple. Basic. You let people know where you stand. You let them know that it's a value, and you let them know that maybe there is pressure that can be put in other places and other ways to help them achieve this goal. But what pressure could you get from a leaderless President Obama and a leaderless administration? We saw what pressure was doing to Iran. We saw that the sanctions were working, sanctions that were meant to cripple the economy of Iran, to get them from going, to keep them from going after nuclear aspirations. What do we do when the sanctions actually start working? Sanctions, by the way, that took years to get Russia on board and China on board. They're not nations that want to be on board. They want Iran to be able to sell freely. We'll get into that in a second. Right when those sanctions were working, President Obama decides that we need a deal on nuclear weapons, so we release the sanctions, we lessen the sanctions, and then the Iranians, they're going to stop, you know, producing their enriched uranium. They're going to stop militarizing their nuclear aspirations. Yet every indication, including those from the Iranians, say, oh, no, that wasn't the deal. We do what we do. We are the people of Iran. We have seen the lack of leadership. And the lack of leadership from President Obama now leads to this very situation. When we come back, I am going to connect the dots on how all of this lack of leadership, all of these places that I'll get into, bring us to this moment in Ukraine, and why it is so incredible that he missed the meeting. This is Tony Katz Tonight.
Veto Senate Bill 1062.
6 more weeks of winter.
Seymour Hoffman.
Shirley Temple has died.
Tonight is our last show for real.
I'm Jimmy Fallon, and I'll be your host.
The worst drought California's ever experienced.
The Seahawks.
Because winning's all that matters when it comes to Daytona.
From what happened in February.
I am a gay man.
To what happens in March.
Ukraine.
The news happens.
We need to watch the Russians.
Here.
Climate change, another weapon of mass destruction.
On the level, on the go. 93 WIBC and WIBC.com.
Bodies of all shapes and sizes, bending, stretching, turning, twisting, motion, suspense, chaos. Korish Dance Company comes to the Tarkington at the Center for the Performing Arts for two nights of turbocharged dance on March 14th and 15th. Beautiful bodies, breathtaking movement, artistic athleticism, an evening of repertoire that combines ballet, modern, and jazz in an unforgettable evening of dance. The evening's highlight, Ravel's Bolero. You've heard Ravel's most celebrated musical composition. Now you can see the piece come to life as Koresh Dance Company converts music into passion. Live at the Tarkington. Tickets at thecenterpresents.org or call 843-3800. Sponsored by St. Vincent Health. Be at the center of it all.
If you're at a Pacers game and suddenly you're struck by a flash of light, it's probably coming from pacemaker dancer Trevasha Winfrey's engagement ring.
When I first got engaged and I had the ring on, and the first game that I was dancing with the ring on, I was just like making sure my left hand was waving all in the air so everyone could see my distinctive diamond engagement ring.
Trevasha says she's thrilled her fiancé Tyler found distinctive diamonds because she didn't want a boring generic ring like you see
all
at the
right,
other
all
store.
Right, all
I
right.
don't like anything
that's
like
right.
cutter. So just something that was unique and fun and bubbly to reflect me was something that I was looking for, and Tyler was able to find a great ring that just fit that exactly at distinctive diamonds.
And nothing makes fiancé Tyler more proud than hearing people say they can see the
ring. Did you see Dallas Buyers Club?
On court.
Not yet.
The game when we all gather, hearing people.
Did you see any of the nominated films?
From the stands. It just makes me feel really good.
Distinctive Diamonds, where Indy gets engaged. Keystone at the Crossing right beside
actually,
the
no.
If you need reliable, high-quality video production,
you're part of the statistic then.
PrimeImageMedia.com.
Most people haven't seen any, have only seen like one of the films. I've seen Captain Phillips.
Event coverage nationwide. Get a high.
I'm trying to think if I've seen any of the others.
Your corporate videos with the most reliable video company in the country. Visit PrimeImageMedia.com today to learn more. Mention Tony Katz and get 10% off your first production. That's PrimeImageMedia.com. PrimeImageMedia.com.
You know the quality of education at public schools is not what it should be. The educational system in the United States is in a major crisis. Your child deserves better. Welcome to American High School, a fully accredited private online school for grades 6 to 12, offering excellent education with high moral standards. If you're a parent concerned about bullying, drugs, and overcrowding in public schools, American High School Online is your answer.
All right, so is the chat room done yelling at me because I'm not going to CPAC?
Certified teachers. Our graduates receive a high school diploma, not a GED. And
I mean, knowing me, I could just decide to show up.
Their choice. Spaces are limited and fill up fast. So call now.
You're like, all right, Paige, no show Thursday. Cover for me.
Financial aid is available.
All Oscars all the time.
312-9305. That's 888-312-9305. Or visit AmericanHighSchool.tv. Don't let your child get any further behind. Call now 888-312-9305. That's 888-312-9305.
Now during Menards Kitchen and Bath Sale, it's the
1 minute
time to update your home. Save big on a fantastic selection of cabinets, sinks, faucets, flooring, plus much more. Complete your kitchen or bath remodel with a new faucet by Delta.
I've been working on this whole leadership thing for a few days now. I don't have it perfectly worked out smooth, but I bring it to the air. It's the only way to do it. You know, I know the thesis, but sometimes, you know, you try and work out the words.
It was another violent weekend in Indianapolis.
Three arrests have been made in connection with the first murder that took place in Indy this year.
Charged with murder in the death of 16-year-old.
One person dead, two people behind bars after
scary
a shooting.
Scary things are happening in our city. Learn how to better protect yourself and your loved ones. Join us March 25th at the WIBC Personal and Home Safety Town Hall. Presented by Protect Your Home, your ADT authorized dealer. Greg Garrison hosts an expert panel at Fountain Square Theater. Details at WIBC.com. talk to Tony Katz, call 800-571-9422 or 239-9393. This is Tony Katz Tonight.
Please welcome the wickedly talented one and only Adele Dazeem.
You're in.
I love her work. Was there anything wrong with the teleprompter, by the way?
You haven't heard that anything's wrong with the teleprompter, so...
That was John Travolta introducing Idina Menzel at the Oscars. And if you call in, Paige will John Travolta-ize your name. There's actually an app now that does it. If you type in your name, and it'll give you what your John Travolta name is, Paige will take care of it for you.
Or I could give it out, and they could do it.
No. It's better that people call in. I mean, we can give out the link, but what's the point? What's the fun of that?
That's true.
I want people calling Paige.
That's right.
We'll put you on the air. And we will introduce you by your John Travolta name when you ask a question.
I like
317-239-9393. By this time of the day, I'm going to get back to everything here on leadership. It's very important. I'm going to connect the dots for you. On a lot of these things, on a lot of subjects, China gets involved in this conversation. Now, I've already brought up Iran. We're talking about what's going on in Ukraine, but how does that take place and affect other things? How did Syria engage part of this conversation? All about leadership. We're going to get into all that. But by this time of the night, ladies and gentlemen, you've heard so many of these stories. Hell, you haven't heard this yet. Admittedly, I'm the first to bring you this. But you've heard story after story again and after again and again, rehashed, rehashed, rehashed. Let me give you something new. We call it the Daily Wrap.
All aboard!
That's the Daily Wrap.
Brought to you by the good people at Rocky Mountain Watch, rockymountainwatch.com, home of the Second Amendment Watch, 866-591-4828. And you can get the Tony Katz Signature Series Tactical Second Amendment Watch. Just tell them you want it. rockymountainwatch.com, 866-591-4828. So what is my name, Paige? What is my John Travolta name?
You had Toby Kazing, or you had... what was the other one? Hang on just a second.
Toby, I like Toby Kazing.
Or you had Toby Knight.
No, that makes me sound like a Backstreet Boy.
It does, actually.
Yeah, I want that. Toby Kazing?
Yeah.
All right. I can that also work as your porn name? I mean, can it be both?
I'd have to look that up and let you know.
There is a teenager in New Jersey. Her name is Rachel Canning. That's not her. Put that in. Let's find out what her John Travolta name is. She is suing her parents. She's 18, by the way. She is suing her parents for her current private school fees and future college tuition after being thrown out of the house for refusing to live by her parents' rules. She's 18. She won't live by her parents' rules. Parents said, get out. And now she's suing them to pay for the rest of her high school and for her college. They say, we love our child and miss her. This is terrible. It's killing me and my wife. We have a child we want home. We're not draconian, and now we're getting hauled into court. She's demanding that we pay her bills, but she doesn't want to live at home. And she's saying, I don't want to live under your rules. The rules, he notes, include reconsidering her relationship with a boyfriend who may be a bad influence, being respectful, and abiding by her curfew. That's it. And she thinks she should get a free ride because, after all, she shouldn't have to listen to any rules. They should just have to pay. If you want to know what has happened culturally to America, there you go. Who does that? Well, the answer is, in a world, we need that. We need that clip. You know what? You win. We need that clip. In a world. We need that. Because in a world where everyone tells you you deserve something for nothing, well, why not? Isn't she justified? Shouldn't parents have to pay for college? Aren't parents nothing more than ATM machines who have no right to tell you? They have no right to know whether or not you're getting an abortion. They have no right to be able to discipline their children. Their job is just to shut up and pay. Be thankful you had kids, you breeder. You were dumb enough to have kids, sucker. Now just pay. This is the best. For months, Rachel, who's an honor student, cheerleader, and lacrosse player, has been living with the family of her best friend and classmate, whatever her name is. The classmate's father is an attorney named John. He is bankrolling Rachel's lawsuit. So she's living at a friend's house. The friend's dad happens to be a lawyer. He's taken on the case, and he is also asking for the family to reimburse his legal fees, which he determines are $12,600. This is you couldn't write this. This is the best level of science fiction anybody has ever come up with. And my thanks to Boston Randy out there for sending me this story. It's now everywhere, by the way. This is the new world order. Now, when you see the at least the website I have, from a Yahoo page. Beautiful young girl, clearly comes from some money, comes from some ducats, private school, things like that. Does she really believe that her parents have no right to tell her how to live her life, even though she's living at their house? And yet they still have to pay for everything. If that is true, if there is a case here, and if she wins the case, I am the first person, Paige, to tell everybody listening, never have children. Stop. Never have children. What's the point? Wait. If you're not in charge of them, if Melissa Harris Perry gets to teach them, right, your children don't belong to you. And now they can sue you because you as a parent are nothing more than a pathetic, ignorant, stupid ATM machine. Your job is just to pay. Our entire life, all our world, has become a Disney sitcom. Don't have kids. Or don't allow yourself to engage these lawsuits. We'll talk about that. This is Tony Katz tonight.
This hour is powered by the Indiana Flower and Patio Show, March 8th through 16th.
It's a huge problem.
2.5-year life.
Right. It destroys companies' reputations. You hear it on the news. Confidential data leaked into the wrong hands. How do you dispose of your computers yet protect your company's reputation and the data you hold confidential? Technology Recyclers is your solution. Technology Recyclers doesn't wipe hard drives and resell your computers. They destroy them and recycle the shredded materials. They provide fast, efficient...
Sorry, I was trying to find In a World for you.
Peace of mind in a world. You, I say that a lot.
Reputation. Their professional drivers will...
I really do. Transport and shred it all. I say that quite a bit. Free.
Technology Recyclers destroys computers, servers, printers, copiers, electronics, and more for businesses, schools, solid waste districts, and many other organizations demanding a peace of mind that their confidential data is destroyed, yet wanting to recycle. Call Technology Recyclers at 1-800-237-3887 or visit tech-recyclers.com.
More than 57,000 grandparents in Indiana, most of them single grandmothers, are raising their grandchildren. According to a recent story in the Indianapolis Star, the rate of Hoosier grand families is rising at double the national average. Hi, I'm Bill Stanjakovich from the Indiana Youth Institute. There are local resources to help grandparents with this challenge. In addition, AARP recommends grandparents raising grandkids ask an attorney if being a guardian would be best for you and your grandchild. Check for aid through government programs and tax.
You're up after how old heating?
Roll your
right on.
In school and speak up if your child needs special service.
We got a lot of heating sponsors.
And take care of your own health so that you have enough energy to keep up with your grandchild. This Kids Count Minute is a message from the Indiana Youth Institute. For more parent tips, join us online at iyi.org/kids.
Kids count on you.
I'm cheap. No, I mean, I'm really cheap. But there is a time when even I have a weak moment and open up my wallet, and that's for my wife. This is Larry from Howald Heating, Air Conditioning, and Plumbing, and with my wife's birthday last week, I turned to the experts at Carrier and brought home an Infinity 98.5% efficient gas furnace. I mean, she's going to love it. She was speechless. I mean, she hasn't spoken to me in 3 days. I really hit a home run on this one, and Mother's Day right around the corner.
5 seconds.
Honey, I'm looking at more efficient washing machines. Howald Heating, coming home never felt so good.
Guys, the Timeshare Cancellation Center, those are the people you need if you have a timeshare and you want to get rid of it. I'm sorry. Of course you want to get rid of it. You just don't know how. You can't put the thing on Craigslist. You can't put it on eBay. Go ahead. Try. I'll wait. Oh, yeah, that's right. It's impossible. You can't sell those things. You can't get rid of those things. You can't get out of those things without help, without the Timeshare Cancellation Center. 888-288-8107. That's the number. 888-288-8107. You can also catch them online at givebackmytimeshare.com. You call them up. You tell them about who you're with. You tell them the problem. Their team of lawyers goes to work doing one thing and one thing only, getting you out of the timeshare and saving you a whole bunch of money in the process. Give them a call, the Timeshare Cancellation Center, 888-288-8107, 888-288-8107, that's 888-288-8107, or check them out online at givebackmytimeshare.com.
First option,
2.5.
Engage the people you call first.
Thinking new home? Great. Home prices are rising at their fastest pace in 36 years. Now is the time to make your move. And now there is yet another reason that your first move should be a call to First Option Mortgage. First Option is now including a home warranty with every new home loan. So you can spend time enjoying your new home instead of spending money on unexpected repairs. So call today. Get a pre-qualification letter and a referral to one of our pre-screened realtor partners. Find your dream home and we'll lower the stress of paying for it and living in it with a free home warranty. First Option Mortgage, the people home buyers call first. First Option Mortgage, 317-713-9500. 713-9500.
First Option Mortgage, the people you call first.
317-713-9500.
Welcome to Sagamore, a private golf club and residential community unlike any other.
That's
managed by
like.
Landscapes Golf Group with a signature course conceit by Jack
Nicklaus.
We
like all the 1%
Sagamore
of stuff.
Is more than golf. It's also a place for...
Hell yes, we do.
Sagamore. Hell yes, we do. What
99% don't get you to Europe.
Sagamore,
no, it doesn't.
Offers a private
and you should know.
And a place where your home can be created just for you by one of the area's finest custom builders. Now is a great time to build your dream home and become part of the Sagamore community. Call 776-2500 today and set up an appointment to experience Sagamore and learn more about building and making your dreams a reality. Call 776-2500 and learn about Sagamore's special home site offer. Receive a full golf membership with a purchase of any developer-owned home site before June 30th. This special home site purchase and membership offer only last until June 30th. So call today. Sagamore Golf Club and Community, 166...
45 seconds.
Between
wow.
State Road
long
37
break,
and I-69. Sagamore, your club, your home.
If you're worried about paying your mortgage, here's some good news. The federal government's Making Home Affordable program has been extended. Also, there are new opportunities...
Fannie Mae is advertising on your program.
If you're having trouble paying your mortgage, additional help is available. Get mortgage relief today.
Nuts.
Visit makinghomeaffordable.gov or call 888-995-HOPE. That's makinghomeaffordable.gov or call
888-995-HOPE. We've been delayed on getting some of the new sponsors in, but that's going to hopefully happen next week.
The madness is almost upon us.
Excited about that.
Get ready to build your bracket and make your picks in the Triple Crown Bracket Challenge at WIBC.com. This is Tony Katz Tonight. Follow Tony on Twitter at Tony Katz.
In a world where
that's not bad. That's not bad. You're close. You know, we just need in the world, not where, in a world. Just got cut it.
I just
right
didn't
there.
Cut him off on quick enough.
Yeah. All right, y'all. You'll fix it in post, as they say in the biz. So making this whole connect the dots here regarding leadership. And thank you, Charlie Norris, who's going to be watching us on YouTube in the archives. He enjoys the shows. I appreciate that. When you subscribe to us at youtube.com/TonyKatzTV and you watch, you can see the whole show happening. You can subscribe and you can see all the old shows and everything else. And I appreciate it. And thank you, Charlie, so much. this whole conversation about leadership. Leadership matters. Leadership is important. And one thing that is clear is that progressives cannot call President Obama a good leader. Those days are over. This isn't something that's up for debate. Very often, subjects are up for debate. You need to have a back and forth. But I have the science. Remember, the science is in. You're not allowed to talk about global warming, right? The science is in, even though, no, it's not. If we went with the science is in, well, then we could say that the Earth is actually flat and the sun does revolve around the Earth. But the science was never in. That's the beauty of science. So maybe I shouldn't say the science is in. I can say, however, that I have the facts and you don't. Because if you disagree with what I'm now going through, well, then it's clear that you think facts are subjective, that facts somehow change. It could be altered. No, no, no. They are what they are. The fact that you don't want to believe them, well, that's your problem, not mine. I discussed Iran, that we had them on the ropes. The sanctions were working. The economy crippled. It would have led, could have led, to a dismantling of their nuclear ambitions. President Obama took that off the table. But we gain nothing from that. It was leadership to try and push the world towards a more nuclear-free society. We are not more nuclear-free. There is now more opportunity to have a nuclear Iran than ever before. Where was the leadership? What was the point? What was the purpose? What was gained? We take a look at Syria, where President Obama, in what I thought was not only strong words from him, I thought it was interesting because it was possible that one could say that maybe he had a point. You could agree or disagree with the point. But being opposed to the use of chemical weapons on citizens, specifically children, is not something where you're going to get people who harshly disagree. They're going to disagree with tactic or style or tactic. Right, but they're not going to say we aren't bothered by the use of chemical weapons on children. And he was going to draw the line, and there was going to be the red line, or the line in the sand. There's some kind of line. I can't keep up with the levels of lines that go on. It's like being at Studio 54 in the 70s. Who can keep up with the lines, ladies and gentlemen? But he was going to get serious. He was going to get tough with Syria. He was going to be serious with Syria, tough and serious with Syria. Right up until the moment where he couldn't, because he wouldn't, because his failings of leadership, of course, forced him to be unable to move forward with any kind of military action. I'm not saying I was for or against a military action. My point is that the President of the United States said something and then didn't live up to it. Didn't back it up. As a matter of fact, he allowed the Russians to bail him out. They were going to handle Syria. No, no, no. Well, we got this. You want me to show you the pictures of Putin and Bashar al-Assad just laughing it up? Man, being a dictator is awesome. That's basically one of the captions underneath. Just another moment in a long line of moments regarding a lack of leadership. We can bring it domestic if you want, and we can simply discuss the IRS scandal. One of the great articles out there is from Victor Davis Hanson. Victor Davis Hanson, if you don't know his work, you should. He has an article over at National Review. I have interviewed him quite a few times in a prior life, and we worked together for a short while. He's a writer over at Pajamas Media, PJ Media, and I worked for a while over at PJ Media. In his article, Ukraine and Our Useless Outrage, he talks about the following, about Assad moving over the American red line, using chemical weapons to gas his own people, and is now winning the war against the Syrian insurgents. In the end, an embarrassed Obama was reduced to denying that he had ever issued a red line in the first place. I didn't set a red line, he said. The world set a red line. You heard me talk about lines. What's a line? What does a line matter? The administration's latest cry of outrage just doesn't seem so absolute either. Remember the president himself. I talk about what's going on domestically. The president himself used that exact adjective to condemn the IRS scandal when it was revealed that the tax agency was inordinately focusing on conservative groups. Later, after various key IRS officials had invoked the Fifth Amendment, resigned, or abruptly retired, Obama brushed off the scandal. It was, he said, mostly a media event conjured up by quote-unquote outraged journalists. Remember, he told Bill O'Reilly it was all Fox News' fault. Somehow, a scandal that the president once decried as institutional abuse ended up as a media melodrama perpetrated by unduly outraged reporters. He said it was outrageous and then did nothing about it. Let me bring you back to Ukraine and why it is so incredibly important to recognize the failing of leadership in not attending the briefing. And I can be given a million reasons why he didn't attend the briefing. I'm still right on this. Go with me. This is the story today at Sky News, that the Russians and China are in agreement over Ukraine. Russia has said China is largely, quote, in agreement, unquote, over Ukraine, after other world powers condemned Moscow for sending troops into the country. Hundreds of Russian soldiers have surrounded a military base in Crimea, preventing Ukrainian soldiers from going in or out. There's actually a report that one of the commanders of the fleet there, of the Navy fleet, has decided to push their allegiance over to Putin after, of course, having their allegiance with Ukraine. So now you have the Russians and the Chinese in a far more cozy relationship, finding things to unite themselves over. Should it be no surprise then that China announces this from freebeacon.com, throw that in the chat room for everybody right there, China announces, or I should say U.S. intelligence agencies confirm, China's development of a new intermediate-range nuclear missile. The new missile is estimated to have a range of at least 2,200 miles, enough for Chinese military forces to conduct attacks on U.S. military facilities in Guam. Why is Guam important? I'm glad you asked. As part of the force posture changes, several thousand Marines, now based in Okinawa, will be moved to Guam as part of the Asia pivot. It's about a lack of leadership, ladies and gentlemen. When we come back, I wrap it all up in a bow. This is Tony Katz Tonight.
While survival of the fittest is a commonly accepted theory, ask yourself this. Are you fit to survive winter's next assault?
Some of the coldest air we've seen.
Wind chills definitely got to be very cold.
When the temperature and the snow drops.
Very, very cold.
Turn to your most trusted ally in the battle to weather winter's worst.
It's pretty slow going. 30 miles an hour.
Temperatures are going to be well below.
On the level, on the go, and in the snow. 93 WIPC. WIPC.com.
The Streisand Samba. All the memories. A loving musical portrait with Ann Hampton Calloway and the Indianapolis Symphony,
all right,
in the Printing Partners Pop Series.
All right, all right.
From Broadway to Hollywood to Barbara's platinum certified albums.
I get a note from Paige in the super secret chat. Nice Coke reference.
Or visit IndianapolisSymphony.org. March 14th and 15th at the Hilbert Symphony.
The fact that you know what Studio 54 is, Paige.
With the Indianapolis Symphony.
They made a movie about it.
Furniture World and Long's Mattress.
Seriously, you have no idea how proud I am at this moment.
How they're made in Jeffersonville, Indiana. How they're 30 to 40.
I'm just a box full of surprises.
It is the wrong use of the word, but Besharet. Really, truly.
And how Bowles has an A-plus rating with the Better Business Bureau. So I thought you might like to hear from a few of our customers.
My name is Marquita Kelly from Indianapolis. I bought my first Bowles mattress from Long's in Southport in September 2010. I was so happy with it, 2 weeks later I came back and bought my son and daughter-in-law a new Bowles mattress. Then in March of this year, I bought another one for our guest room. After sleeping on my Bowles mattress for almost 2 years now, and after being so well treated by Doug and his staff, I can't imagine buying any other mattress but Bowles. Bowles makes a great bed.
But as always, don't take our word for it. Come on into one of our four Indy locations in Franklin, Southport, Avon, and Castleton and check out a Bowles mattress for yourself. Find us at longsfurnitureworld.com.
Disclaimers at cnctaxprogram.com. If the IRS claims you owe back taxes, you could qualify for a special tax program, and you won't make any payments to the IRS. That's right. I said if you qualify for the CNC tax program, you won't make any payments to the IRS while in this program. Get ready to write down the most important number you may ever need to finally end your IRS nightmare. This toll-free number should only be used if you can't afford to pay any money to the IRS. Call 800-652-2599. Now to see if you qualify for the CNC tax program. Once you're accepted, the IRS must stop all collection activities against you. No more threatening phone calls, no wage garnishments or bank levies, and no more monthly payments to the IRS. Just call 800-652-2595 now to find out if you qualify for the CNC tax program. You won't make any payments to the IRS while in this program. Call 800-652-2595 now. That's 800-652-2595. 800-652-2595. Again, 800-652-2595.
Do you know why virtually everyone in Indy gets their diamond jewelry at Distinctive Diamonds?
Well, do ya?
Rock bottom prices. We are a true direct importer, started by former diamond wholesalers over a dozen years ago.
He got mine at Jared.
Come from a corporate home office. No, he didn't. Office.
He did because we went to go to a place in Sacramento and they were closed. We couldn't find them.
That's how we consistently beat everyone else's diamond prices, local or online.
So we went to Jared.
But before we let you buy, we teach you the inside secrets of the diamond business, showing you ways to maximize your budget so you can buy like a dealer buys. Then there's our unrivaled selection of handcrafted designer rings.
1 minute.
Like Simon G, Jeff Cooper, Henry Dossie, Kirk Cara, and more. We make finding her dream ring easy. And after the sale, we guarantee to service your ring at no charge for life. Who else does this? This is why we are the undisputed leader and why we continue to be voted the best place in Indy for rings and the best local jewelry store. Discover Indy's own Distinctive Diamonds. Keystone at the Crossing.
Indianapolis, the holidays are over, and the bills are coming.
Barbara, you've been to Studio 54?
Don't stress disorder anymore. Go to MeridianMortgageSolutions.net and consolidate that high-interest credit card debt. Enjoy no payments till spring and get a low fixed rate starting in the threes, all with little to no out-of-pocket closing cost. Call 317-968-9500 or apply online at MeridianMortgageSolutions.net.
All loans and rates are subject to credit approval. Programs and rates are subject to change. Additional terms and conditions apply. Equal housing lender. See lender for restrictions and details. NMLS number 2975.
Experience the Showcase Gardens, redesigned urban homestead, and more at the Indiana Flower and Patio Show.
Been to Studio 54, have you? My oh my.
IndianaFlowerAndPatioShow.com.
This is Tony Katz Tonight. Follow Tony on Twitter at Tony Katz.
The wickedly talented one and only Adele Dazeem.
All right, all right, all right.
You're it.
Tony Katz Tonight. 317-239-9393. Toll free 800-571-9422. We'll be getting into the Oscars in the next hour. You will not want to miss it. And also, deporting a family of Germans for wanting to be in the United States to be able to homeschool, something that's not allowed in Germany. Why? Because they actually want to be able to practice their faith. It's an interesting story. We'll get into all of it. But I will finish this up. It was necessary. Trying to connect these dots about the conversation of leadership. You've heard me talk about the constant level of ultimatums that are meaningless. We've seen it throughout history, but we've seen it a tremendous amount under President Obama. We have seen it regarding the Russians and Ukraine, the people there trying to remove Viktor Yanukovych, the Russians wanting to continue, it seems, to prop him up. how he moved away from dealing with the Europeans to be more in Putin's pocket. Promised money to help fix things in Ukraine. That money never came. You saw President Obama. I mean, he's making these wild gestures, if you will. These lines in the sand, but we've seen the lines before. Outraged about the IRS, does nothing about it. No leadership. Outraged about Syria, does nothing about it. No leadership. You now see China, which has announced its new ability in terms of missiles, saying that they're with the Russians on what's going on in Ukraine. Because when you don't have leadership, there is nothing to fear. One of the great misnomers is that somehow leadership means force. Does not. It means a clear set of values and beliefs by which you operate so everybody knows what will happen if. In good and in bad. Nobody knows what will happen if with President Obama in good or in bad. Why is it that we have a labor participation rate as low as it was in 1978? Because nobody knows if they can hire. They don't know what's going to happen to them. And companies that know that they're being affected, for example, by Obamacare, again, a total lack of leadership. It's not his fault that Obamacare isn't working. Republicans won't work with them. This one won't work with them. The website's doing this. This is happening over here. It's raining. It's sunny. It's too much sun. My golf game, my back. I got to go on vacation. Never-ending sea of what gets in the way, as opposed to just taking responsibility. The idea of these values that lead the way. I talk about the businesses not being able to hire. When you're a business that has over 99 employees and you don't want to be affected by Obamacare, so you're going to lay some people off, which seems prudent, and now you're told that you have to swear to the IRS under penalty of perjury that you won't fire people because of Obamacare? That's not leadership in terms of we're going to enforce this law. What do you call that? That's extortion.
Thuggery?
Well, thuggery, you'll be called a racist. So I go extortion. You know, if it's good enough to call it, if it's good enough to call Italians extortionists, then it's good enough to call Obamacare clearly extortion. Maybe there's a better word. All of this, this lack of leadership. When you see the Russians and the Chinese together, I have to go back to Iran. The lack of leadership. How does it all tie together? We relax the sanctions on Iran. Iran is now able to participate in the selling of oil. You have China, which is a very, very thirsty country for energy. So they are going to be a unique buyer of this oil. You have Russia, which has its own economic issues, and China, which has the capability to help them out. After all, they have the same geopolitical desires, at least in some cases, not every case. Some. Certainly there are some mutual interests there. So the total lack of leadership from President Obama, the kowtowing, and the allowing himself to be submissive in front of Putin on Syria and pushing forth a deal with Iran that had no business being pushed, now has the ability to feed China oil, to have China helping out Russia with its economic issues. Russia can continue to dominate Ukraine, or at least the Crimean Peninsula. And the United States has done what? The United States, when at least came to a moment of showing the world that they were interested in what was happening, President Obama didn't show up to the national security briefing. He symbolically left the chair empty. And sometimes the symbolism is all you have left. Russia and China and Iran and Syria and the world now know for sure that this president at this time has no capacity to stand up for anything, because the truth is what he believes in doesn't involve those people. He could care less about foreign policy. It does not matter to him. His entire life, his entire worldview is about the domestic agenda. The agenda that you see in front of you. The agenda of big government. The agenda of big spending. When you don't have leadership, you allow others to take control. So I ask you, progressives, what is it like in a world where Russia, China, Iran, and Syria have more control? The days of calling President Obama a leader are over. Empty suit, empty chair, empty promises, empty the Senate in 2014. We have much more ahead, including the Oscar talk. Paige is so happy. This is Tony Katz Tonight.
If you're 55 or older, you just graduated to be a senior.
Well, at least with Unique Home Solutions, March Fall Prevention Sale.
There's 25% off any bath makeover for folks 55 and older, and that includes labor.
All right, guys,
labor.
We are back.
Unique and Sequoia have partnered to make bathing safer for mature Hoosiers. Sequoia and Unique have great free information on fall prevention, and now there's savings on the new safe bath you've wanted anyway.
With spring almost here, why not take advantage of savings on a beautiful, safe bathroom with no worry about maintenance?
Unique safe baths can reduce risk in the most likely place to fall, your bathroom.
For answers on fall prevention, go to IndieCreativeAging.org. And to save 25% on a new safe bath if you're 55 or over, just call Unique.
Unique Home Solutions, 1-800-800-1971.
Are you looking for a church where you can connect with God in a beautiful, sacred space?
Pastor John Gable of Tabernacle Presbyterian Church.
Where do you best connect with God? In a park? At your kitchen table? It's wonderful that we can have fellowship with God in many different places. Set foot into the sanctuary at Tab and you know that you are in a special, sacred space. The soaring Gothic architecture and the beautiful stained glass tell you that this is a tabernacle, a place where God dwells. Of course, it's not the stone or wood or glass that makes a place sacred. It's what happens between God and God's people whenever we gather to worship and pray and sing. I invite you to come visit us and discover this sacred space for yourself.
Tabernacle Presbyterian Church, 34th Street and Central Avenue in Indianapolis, invites you to worship Sunday morning at 8, 9, or 11. If you can't make it in person, tune into Sunday with Tab, Sunday mornings at 6:30 on WIBC. To learn more about Tab, visit us at tabprez.org.
My biggest goal in my life right now is just to be happy.
I would really, really love to backpack out west.
The biggest goal for myself right now is making it through school.
To get my whole house remodeled.
To raise a happy, healthy family.
Live well. Chase your dreams. And along the way, make the decision to become an organ donor so you can give someone else the chance to chase their dreams, too. Learn more at DonateLifeIndiana.org. Brought to you by the Indiana Broadcasters Association and this station.
The news and talk of Indiana, 93 WIBC. From the Plumbing, Heating, Paramedic Studios.
This is Central Indiana's news, weather, and traffic station.
93 WIBC, Indianapolis.
Fox News Radio, I'm Bill Vitka. Deadline. Ukraine forces say this is the hour set by Russian Black Sea Fleet Commander for Ukrainian forces stationed in Crimea to lay down their weapons or be stormed. Russia denies there's an ultimatum. The conflicting reports threaten to worsen already frayed tensions over the crisis in Ukraine.
In the Black Sea outside Sevastopol, the Russian Navy are maneuvering. They're putting on a show of force, sending a message. We're here and we are in control. They're blocking in these ships from the Ukrainian Black Sea fleet, still flying the flag, but now cut off at a small base across the bay. This is a Ukrainian naval facility where we're told the remaining operating ships from Sevastopol have been brought. They're being blocked in by the Russians at sea. And one man leaving has just told us they'll be flying the Russian flag overhead.
Katie Stallard of Fox Sister Network Sky News. Secretary of State John Kerry is heading to Kiev right now to show support for Ukrainian sovereignty. A Phoenix police officer has been killed in a shootout with a man wanted on a felony who also died in the gun battle. Another officer is in critical condition, fighting for his life. The confrontation began with the suspect fleeing in his car, setting off a three-car crackup, and the chase continued on foot, guns blazing along the way. Jury selection has begun in New York in the trial of an alleged al-Qaeda spokesman and son-in-law of Osama bin Laden.
Now, Suleiman Abu Ghaith was in court today. He was not wearing handcuffs, but he was wearing a khaki suit with no tie. He listened through a translator, and the judge asked him to turn to the potential jurors, and then asked them if any of them knew him. None of them said that they did. He also asked the potential jurors if any of them had never heard of al-Qaeda, and again, none of them spoke up there. The opening statements in this case are expected to start on Wednesday.
Fox's Leah Gabriel. The big shadow cast over the markets, the crisis in Ukraine, the Dow falling 153. You're listening to Fox News Radio, fair and balanced.
Weekdays on Fox Business.
Bottom line here is we want investors to be prepared for the day ahead, the week ahead.
Opening bell with Maria Bartiromo.
The concept is to bring perspective, analysis. All day long, I'm speaking with global allocators of capital, CEOs, heads of state, so I can anticipate some of the major moves or reactions, giving investors an edge.
Opening bell with Maria Bartiromo. Weekdays at 9 a.m. Eastern on Fox Business.
On point, outspoken, always Hannity.
I have a message for this president, this administration.
Now, more than ever, we need a place for honest conversation.
Why can't you just say he was wrong?
Open debate and a real dialogue on the tough issues.
Debt has risen nearly $7 trillion. I don't want that for any community in this country. Republicans can't give in to this bullying.
A voice not afraid to be heard.
What part of that are you understanding? That was the wrong thing to do. Conservatives, you need to hold the line.
Watch Hannity weeknights on Fox News Channel.
You may not believe it, but the best of both worlds is indeed possible when it comes to your retirement nest egg. On one hand, you want to enjoy positive market returns, but on the other hand, you never want to lose a single dollar. Guess what?
The chick's on the right here to tell you that with Brian Singer, you can get the best of both worlds in two easy steps. Step number one, go to singerfinancialgroup.com and click on the Ready to Retire icon. This interactive tool will help you define the what, when, where, and how for your retirement.
Step number two, call 317-852-9153 to schedule a free personal review and learn how you can create a customized safe money GPS to guide you to and through your ideal retirement. Singer Financial Group, they do income planning, not guessing.
Enjoying positive market returns and never losing money is indeed the best of both worlds. Go to singerfinancialgroup.com, click on the Ready to Retire icon, and then call 317-852-9153. That's 317-852-9153.
I'm Alex Brown in the 93 WIBC 24-hour news center. An Indiana National Guardsman faces federal explosives charges.
Andrew Boguslawski faces charges of possession of unregistered destructive devices, a crime punishable by up to 10 years in prison. State charges have been dropped. Boguslawski was pulled over by an Ohio State Highway Patrol trooper for speeding on I-70 west of Columbus early New Year's Day. The trooper noticed 13 explosive devices that looked similar to 5-hour energy drink bottles.
You think, Randy?
Bomb squad determined they were
explosive. You think it's...
A search of the vehicle revealed firearms, ammunition, and detonators. Boguslawski...
Hey, Tony.
Yeah, what's up?
From visiting family...
I'm going to have a little bit of fun before I tell you you're in.
Columbus, Ohio, Matt Brody.
You enjoy yourself because you're just...
Greenwood High School teacher Timothy Guilfoy has resigned after he was arrested March 1st, naked in his truck with an underage female student. Guilfoy told officers he and the girl were having sex and that she was a student of his at the high school. Guilfoy had been with the Greenwood Community School Corporation since 2000. He faces preliminary charges of child seduction with formal charges pending. House Speaker Brian Bosma won't say who offered him unlimited campaign contributions if he would shut down the same-sex marriage amendment without a vote, but he says it was not the only such offer.
There was an offer to another person that lives in my district of $500,000 in campaign funding. If that person was willing to run against me in the primary based on HJR 3.
The Associated Press quotes sources who say it was Jim Kittle, the former state Republican Party chairman, who made the offer to Bosma. You're up to date. Get local news on demand at WIBC.com. Now here's the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
An additional 1 to possibly 3 inches of snow in central Indiana. We're not done yet. Temperatures that have been hovering around 20 drop into the single digits tonight.
So strange.
As the snowfall fades away as we get into the late.
This is the wrong weather.
I'm RTV6 meteorologist Kevin.
Oh, is it? That's never good, Paige.
Yeah, I have to tell the Mark.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Tony Katz Tonight.
The wickedly talented.
Tony Katz Tonight.
You are it.
Well done. So, can I just tell you that during the break, Twitter just signed me off? Like, and then all of a sudden told me that I have to put in a new password? The heck was that all about? That's just going to be annoying.
Did someone hack you?
No, I'm not hacked in any way. I'm in. But all of a sudden, I was trying to upload something, and it said, oh, okay, now you got to put in your username and password again. Okay, fine. Sometimes, I guess, crazy stuff can happen. I do it, and next thing you know, I have to change my password. I like my password. So now I change my password, and I'm going to go back and try and change my password again to a password I can at least remember. All my passwords end in Holly Bacon. That's the way it is. Tony Katz Tonight, everybody. Great to be with all of you. 317-239-9393. Toll free, 800-571-9422. Online, TonyKatz.com. Just click on the radio show link. Quite literally says the radio show. And then you can see the program, get in on the chat room, all sorts of good things. And I even have trolls in the chat room today. So, you know, it's a lovely day.
I see that.
I know. Charles, by the way, Charlie Norris wants his John Travolta name. So since John Travolta cannot pronounce a name and clearly had himself a moment, what would be, if your name was Charlie Norris, what would your John Travolta name be?
Your name would be, just let me type it in, Charlotte Nachimes.
It would be what?
Charlotte Nachimes.
How do you even get that?
I don't know.
Wow. So should we, should I do that first? Should I do the Oscars first? Because it was, I can start with an article that I wrote, or I can start with I'm going to start with that. Because I wrote an article today over at Rare having to do with the selfie. Did you see the selfie?
I did.
Okay. The most retweeted photo in the history of Twitter at the time that I wrote my article was 2.7 million retweets. 2.7 million. I'll check to see where it is now. Because now it's just, you know, a self-fulfilling prophecy that you have to reach. Okay, 3 million. 3 million retweets and counting on this selfie photo. It's Jennifer Lawrence and Meryl Streep, and there's Julia Roberts, there's Kevin Spacey, Brad Pitt, Lupita, I cannot pronounce her last name. What's her last name?
Nyong'o.
Thank you.
And her date. I don't know.
No, it's not her date. That's her brother.
Her brother, right. Yeah. He's her date, wasn't
right.
he?
Right. I don't like to say date when it's the brother. It's her brother. Mm. All right? Now, if I was talking about Angelina Jolie, you could say the brother was the date.
Yes.
Right?
You could.
Clearly, you could say
you
that.
French him afterwards, too.
You know, Angelina Jolie there with that hand kind of obscuring her. Bradley Cooper. There's Ellen, and there's Jared Leto's weird left eye, which should have its own Twitter account as far as I'm concerned. So, okay.
Jared Leto's left eye.
Take a look at the photo. It's just staring
new
at you.
Member of TLC.
So he is the new, yeah, Jared Left Eye. Jared Left Eye Leto. That's correct. Nice. So I noted the fact that, you know, the photo was just, it was fun. Listen, I'm not talking about praising celebrity culture. I'm not talking about saying that everything celebrity is important, but it was a photo at the Oscars. It was fun. Good. All right, they enjoyed themselves. When you see a group of actors, right, self-aggrandizing or self-congratulating kind of actors who lament life struggles while shopping at Cartier. I get you. I don't want to hear anything about celebrity. This was the Oscars. The photo was fine. Did you have any problem with the page?
No, I thought it was, I mean, you know, it was, I was entertained at least.
I was entertained too. I thought it was a good moment. So you have people who immediately took this and got political with it. I didn't even know it was possible, but they figured out a way. So the left is all of a sudden very upset with the photo. Why are they upset with the photo? There is a photo of President Obama hugging the First Lady, Michelle Obama, that was the most retweeted photo in history, 700 some odd thousand retweets. This photo with Ellen was set to break that. So people started tweeting, wait, didn't realize that the most retweeted pic is of Barack Obama, Michelle Obama, taking my Ellen selfie retweet back. Sad face that Ellen's selfie passed the Barack Obama 2012 record. And then this is the best one. Ellen is going to break Obama's record any second now. So thanks a lot, America. You are awful and deserve President Palin. How did Sarah Palin get in the conversation? She wasn't even at the Oscars.
She was in Alaska just chilling.
Well, clearly, it's what you do in Alaska. But it's crazy, right? That is the definition of unhinged. If a photo of somebody else gets more retweets than President Obama, it is the end of the world. That is unhinged. When you think, as I wrote there at Rare, when you think America is awful for retweeting a photo of Frank Underwood looking like he just got goosed, you're not okay. You're indecent. Unfortunately, though, some on the right decided that this was a moment that shouldn't pass either. And let me tell you, you see these things and you're like, man, these people do not know in any way, shape, or form how to win a culture war at all. And some of the people I like, and some of the people are from places that I respect, and this happened from one of the guys over at The Blaze, a radio host named Doc Thompson, who I don't think meant anything malicious. I think that if it's just this knee-jerk reaction to celebrity culture, which is a bad idea. He posted a photo, and he said that this should be the most retweeted photo in Twitter history. And the photo is that of the United States Constitution. Now, it is one thing to say that we're celebrity obsessed, and that America is celebrity obsessed. It is. We know far too much about Justin Bieber. We care way too much about who John Mayer is sleeping with, and I have no idea how he gets all these women. Paige, I don't understand. I mean, John Mayer, really? Would you? Can I ask that? Am I allowed to ask? I'm asking that.
You want to, I mean,
John Mayer?
Married, maybe.
No, you're not married. No. Christian. No, all bets are off. You know the guy, you know the story.
Lost my religion.
John Mayer. Wait, lost your religion. Does that mean you were drunk?
No, I mean, this isn't like the REM song. I'm just, as a Christian, I mean, I'm not really into the whole premarital sex thing. But, yeah, I mean, I'll tell you, my sister and I have a big John Mayer crush.
Oh, so. God.
She and I, whenever we get together, she's like, have you heard the latest John Mayer song?
Oh, I'm not talking to you.
We're little hens.
It is so hard to talk to you sometimes.
What? The man's an amazing musician.
And after everything, there's still women who will go to bed with him. Still. Of the celebrity caliber. Still. But I'll get back to that. We will let you ruminate on that for just a minute. But it's not an obsession of celebrity, in my opinion, when you're at the Oscars. And the world has always had an obsession with celebrity. The people who make the movies, the books, the plays, the operas, the music, the sports. It's escapism. It's always been a part of who we are. It's always been wanted. And celebrating those who hit the high notes, make the play come to life, who throw the winning touchdown or write the meaningful passage, have always been people that are in some regard admired. The Constitution is an amazing gift. It's a recognition of what rights clearly come from nature and nature's law, and a reminder of how quickly liberty can be snuffed out by an unruly gang of Harvard street toughs who think they're better than you. I agree that the Constitution is more important than celebrity, but this isn't a conversation of what's more important. It was a cool photo. And to bring ideology into the mix over a photo is exactly what the culture war isn't about. It drove me nuts to see that tweet and to see these people talking about how dare you retweet more than Obama. There's a rule now? Like in D.C., you can't build anything taller than the Washington Monument. You can't have any photo retweeted more than President Obama. This is culture war fail 101, and we can't afford it. We've got much more on the Oscars, including Paige's take. This is Tony Katz tonight.
Another WIBC news update is minutes away.
Latest wave of snow, less than expected.
We've lucked out with the storm system staying a little further to our south.
Then find out what it means to you with Garrison.
I don't know what that groundhog did or said, but whatever it was, it didn't work.
Rush.
Spoiler alert for the Liam Neeson movie at a website called Chicks on the Right.
Dana, the Chicks, and Abdul.
Abdul, you arrogant liberal.
Darn right. I'm loving every minute of it.
On the level, on the go. 93 WIBC and WIBC.com.
No matter where you stand on the issue of war, our sons, daughters, neighbors, and friends are fighting for freedom for all of us. Adopt a Platoon, Soldier Support Effort, was organized by caring mothers nationwide to ensure that American service men and women are not forgotten and to promote patriotism in schools and communities. Currently, AAP is in need of Americans who will step forward to support a U.S. service member deployed overseas with cards, letters, and care packages. Supporters are matched with individual soldiers who need to know that America is behind them. Morale is a special emotion, and your small effort is greatly appreciated by young men and women so far from home. Put a smile on a soldier's face today by sending a letter. Either you, your church, civic club, company, or your Friday Girls Night Out group can adopt a single soldier or a whole platoon. Visit adoptaplatoon.org. Adopt a Platoon, supporting our deployed sons and daughters.
Hey, Daisy, I know I told you about how Zero Res came to clean my carpets a few weeks ago and how the entire experience was just a big, giant pile of awesome sauce, but did I mention that the floors still look great? They put magical stain guard stuff on them, too.
I know, Mock. I'm dying for them to come back out and do more rooms in my house. Hmm. The difference between the tile flooring that they cleaned and the flooring that they haven't yet is just amazing.
All right.
About cleaning my floors. It's because Zero
Res... So, you ready, Paige, to give your thoughts? Water,
which is like
I'm ready.
Hocus-pocus magic that cleans without soap, detergent, or surfactant. It's high-tech and it works.
And they're running a special where you get three rooms and a hallway, Zero Resified, starting at just $129.
Best deal ever!
Now that I know that they don't just clean carpets and tile, but almost every other surface you can think of, I have a huge list of stuff I want them to clean.
You guys have to call them and see for yourself. It's 317-388-5141.
That's 317-388-5141 or visit them at ZeroResIndy.com. Spelled backwards or forwards, it's the right way to clean.
You know the quality of education at public schools is not what it should be. The educational system in the United States is in a major crisis. Your child deserves better. Welcome to American High School, a fully accredited private online school for grades 6 to 12, offering excellent education with high moral standards. If you're a parent concerned about bullying, drugs, and overcrowding in public schools, American High School Online is your answer. You'll have access to our counselors and certified teachers. Our graduates receive a high school diploma, not a GED, and the ability to attend the college of their choice. Spaces are limited and fill up fast, so call now for free enrollment information. Financial aid is available. Call now 888-312-9305. That's 888-312-9305 or visit American High.
Send your love to Holly, everybody. Tomorrow, hopefully all goes well.
Call now 888-312-9305. That's 888-312-9305.
If you need reliable, high-quality video production, look no further than PrimeImageMedia.com. PrimeImageMedia.com provides promotional videos, training videos, and conference and event coverage nationwide. Get a high-quality, consistent look to your corporate videos with the most reliable video company in the country. Visit PrimeImageMedia.com today to learn more. Mention Tony Katz and get 10% off your first production. That's PrimeImageMedia.com. PrimeImageMedia.com.
Used to be you'd pat a fellow grower on the back to congratulate him on a decision that paid off. Nowadays, you see fellas bump knuckles. Out here, we call it the yield bump. Like the bump in yield potential you get with Stratego Yield fungicide. Stratego Yield features advanced chemistry for proven disease control. healthier fields and higher yields.
Not a commercial I was expecting.
That's why
glad
it's
playing, though.
The official fungicide of the yield bump. And with an early season application of Stratego Yield, you can get a head start on your yield bump. Adding an early treatment fights disease development for even higher yield potential than tassel sprays alone. So put her there. Ask your dealer about including Stratego Yield in a tank mix with your post-emergence corn herbicide.
Less than 30.
Stratego
right on.
Fungicide from Bayer. Healthy fields, higher yields. Learn more at strategoyield.us or talk to your dealer. Always read and follow label instructions.
I'm Gary Dick. Inside Indiana Business Radio provides the breaking news you need to get ahead. Indiana's business news leader, weekdays at 6:40 a.m. and 5:35 p.m. on WIBC.
You're listening to Tony Katz Tonight. To talk to Tony, call 239-9393.
You're it.
So interesting that Apple CEO Tim Cook has shocked some in the U.S. with an impassioned attack on the single-minded pursuit of profit, says the company with $150 billion in cash. He was visibly angry as he took on a group of right-wing investors, this is from The Independent, during a question-and-answer session at a shareholders meeting, basically said, if you want me to do things only for ROI reasons, you should get out of this stock. He was specifically asked about green projects and global warming and things like that. I think it's important that he let you know. Now you can decide whether or not you should be invested in Apple. It's totally your call. By the way, full disclosure, I do not own any Apple stock, but I use Macs, and I use an iPhone, and I use iPads. I also use a PC. I also use a bunch of other things. Not computers, I'm just saying. I use a lot of stuff to do this show. Tony Katz tonight, great to be with all of you. We are discussing the Oscars. And Paige will give you your Oscar name, your John Travolta name, if you ask for it. So you watched, Paige. You watched the Oscars. You are our official entertainment reporter. Let's start with the basics. Ellen DeGeneres, yay or nay?
I liked it.
What did you like?
I just think it wasn't over the top, and she kept it funny, you know? I mean, and somewhat entertaining. I mean, for what it has been in the past, where it just seems like it's god-awful and drags on forever, I felt like she kept it moving.
There are some who say that she really gave up in the last 30 minutes. She just gave up. It's like, all right, we're done here. Is this over yet?
No, I think it's they started cutting stuff for time, you know?
How do you know no matter, they start cutting stuff for time? What were you? Were you there?
Well, no, but I mean, so, like, if you watch the beginning, Pharrell's Happy song, he got to sing the whole song. When they got to Let It Go from Frozen, they only had her sing one verse and then the chorus and kind of the build-up because they needed to start cutting stuff.
You don't think that was just planned?
I mean, it might have been, but I think that was the song, because of where they placed it, they wanted people to keep watching, and they knew they would watch for that song, because they have all the people with their little kids who have loved that song, mm-hmm. gone to the sing-alongs in theaters, blah, blah, blah. So
you seem to know a lot about the sing-alongs.
I do, because I have nieces, and I would go if it were age appropriate. I won't lie to you. I love that movie, but I just think they needed to start getting it done because they knew the speeches are also going to get longer from that point on.
Well, so you give her a thumbs up. I am totally noncommittal on Ellen. I think that there's a natural kind of awkwardness to her comedy, but I don't think it works necessarily when you're just going to walk through the audience and not just either pick on people or ask questions. It doesn't work. But let us move off of her and on to highlights. It was the highlight Matthew McConaughey's speech, which was kind of shocking yet wonderful, honest and forthright. Was it who was the woman who was totally frozen? Was it the jokes about Liza Minnelli? What was your moment?
Honestly, it was Travolta. Like, I just was, because it was such a clear mess up.
Now, if you didn't hear it, John Travolta was there to introduce Idina Menzel, who was singing the song from Frozen. What is the name of the song? Is it
Let
Go?
It Go. Let It Go.
Oh, Let It Go. Okay. And this,
we'll be playing it later. Don't you worry.
Oh, the song or the clip? Now, I want you to play the clip right now. This is John Travolta, who, by the way, he's had plastic surgery or he's had just a lot of Botox?
Oh, it could be both. And
just a ton of Botox. I mean, he didn't look okay. He did not look well. This was him. The woman's name is Idina Menzel, admittedly. It's not Sarah Smith. It's not the everyday name. This is him
doing
it.
But it's not like they pulled her at the last minute.
No. She is not an unknown, and he had time to practice, and he said wickedly very well.
Right.
So,
are you ready?
Play it.
I love you. There will always be a special place in my heart for the movie musical and for the songs that create their most memorable moments. Here to perform the Oscar-nominated, gorgeously empowering song, Let It Go, from the Oscar-winning animated movie Frozen, please welcome the wickedly talented one and only Adele Dazeem.
Gorgeously empowering. He got that right.
I just love the way he says wickedly talented. Like, he knows her. Like, she's wickedly talented. Adele Dazeem. And it's like, what? Because I knew she was supposed to be singing it, I thought maybe they'd pulled Adele, and I just didn't know Adele's last name. So then when I saw it was Idina, I was like, what?
The best part is I get a text from Paige before the show begins, and she's like, just so you know, I'm going to be talking about this.
I wanted you to know your name.
This is going to happen a lot during the program. We are going to discuss John Travolta in depth. It's going to be Travolta 101 and 102 tonight.
Oh, because it was just such a good moment.
What do you think happened to him? I mean, it wasn't a mini stroke. What happened?
I've witnessed a mini stroke. It wasn't that. Yeah, you know, I don't know if it was the teleprompter. I mean, I don't know if he's one of those that can, you know, blame the teleprompter. But I'm not, because there was some confusion earlier in the show. Charlize Theron was out there, I think it was with Channing Tatum, and they were presenting, and she was supposed to say, and the nominees are, and she's just standing there.
Okay, all right. So that's a little different.
Than totally butchering somebody's name.
The wickedly talented Bob Saget. He would have been the same thing, you know?
It really would have. I just died laughing because I was like, what are you doing? I don't know if it was nerves or...
How could it be nerves?
It could be one of
those
things.
John Travolta, what nerves?
You know what it reminds
me of? He did Battlefield Earth.
Right.
What?
That's a good point.
What nerves are left?
I don't know. It reminds me of when my sister was graduating, and her middle name is McCall, but of course my mom spelled it weird, and so the administrators, you know, called everyone in to make sure they could get the names right, and of course my sister has a weird spelling for Taryn, a weird spelling for McCall, and then our maiden name is Finkbonner, so have fun with that.
We got to take the break, but right. John Travolta is the only man in America who had totally rebuilt his career and destroyed his career. I'm going to stick with that. Keep it here. This is Tony Katz tonight.
This hour is powered by the Indiana Flower and Patio Show, March 8th through 16th.
MD Anderson Cancer Center in Houston, Texas, resembles a city within a city. Over 19 million square feet of hope. The largest freestanding cancer center in the world. Community Health Network now has over 20 doctors certified through its affiliation with MD Anderson Cancer Network. That is a pretty big deal. Nowhere else in central Indiana can you have access to the nation's top cancer experts.
2 minutes to your life.
MD Anderson doesn't collaborate with just anybody. They chose community as much as community wanted them. This affiliation...
Actually, just kidding a minute because I just pulled a PSA.
Good for you.
Leader in cancer care.
Good for you.
Right here at home.
It was hiding.
I don't know why they're in there.
Changes everything. In the race against...
We talked about it.
Well, because the computer autofills them.
Just took the lead. Visit ecommunity.com/cancercare. Exceptional care, simply delivered. The pursuit is on.
MD Anderson Cancer Network is a program of the University of
Texas. You're up after Fannie Mae.
Cancer Center.
If you're worried about paying your mortgage, here's some good news. The federal government's Making Home Affordable program has been extended. Also, there are new opportunities for more struggling homeowners to qualify. If you're having trouble paying your mortgage, additional help is available. Get mortgage relief today. Visit makinghomeaffordable.gov
10 seconds.
Or call 888-995-HOPE. That's makinghomeaffordable.gov or call 888-995-HOPE.
Guys, the Timeshare Cancellation Center, they're there for you because you need help. If you have a timeshare, you want to get out of that timeshare, it doesn't happen on your own. It's like having the stuck pickle jar. You can't open that thing. The last thing you want to do is break the jar and get cut. You need somebody with a strong hand. Just the right amount of glide to get that done. That's a timeshare cancellation center. I just related a pickle jar page to your timeshare. That's how good I am. 888-288-8107. That's the number, 888-288-8107. Or online at givebackmytimeshare.com. You tell them about the problem. You tell them who you're with. Their team of lawyers goes to work doing one thing and one thing only, getting you out of the timeshare and saving you a whole bunch of money in the process. Give them a call and start saving money right now, 888-288-8107, 888-288-8107, 888-288-8107, or check them out online at givebackmytimeshare.com.
The Streisand Songbook, All the Memories, a loving musical portrait with Anne Hampton Calloway and the Indian.
I have one other favorite part too for the Oscars.
Partners pop series from Broadway.
I just sent you a message.
Hollywood to Barbara's platinum certified albums. Call 317-639-4300 for tickets or visit IndianapolisSymphony.org. March 14th and 15th at the Hilbert Circle Theater. The Streisand Songbook with the Indianapolis Symphony.
Caring for my aging mother, I felt alone, guilty, pressure, and then I found Joyce House.
This is Tina McIntosh. Joyce House is committed to supporting families by providing exceptional adult day services. Joyce House allows you, the caregiver, the opportunity to ease the pressure of outside stress by giving your loved one a safe community during the day.
I take care of Mom, and when I need to catch up with life, Mom has Joyce House.
1 minute. We know you love your parent, and at Joyce House, we do too. Click on joycehouse.org for more information, and when you're ready to visit with your loved one, just give me a call at 254-0828. I also invite you to join me and Terry Stacy every Saturday morning from 8 to 9 on 93 WIBC for Caregiver Crossing, a service of Joyce House, as we come together for a discussion of the ups and downs of caring for a loved one. Again, find out more at joyshouse.org.
It's a fantastic time to update your home with beautiful new flooring from Menards. Save big on carpet, laminate, vinyl, and more styles of flooring at super low prices. Give any room a great new look with Great Lakes Hardwood Flooring. It offers the warm, natural beauty of wood. Save big on 3-inch solid hickory flooring by Great Lakes Wood Floors. Now just $438 per square foot. Your savings place for top quality flooring. Menards.
Save big money at Menards.
Join us for the WIBC Personal and Home Safety Town Hall Meeting presented by ABT Security Systems on March 25th. Find all the details at WIBC.com. You're listening to Tony Katz tonight. To talk to Tony, call 239-9393.
You're...
Oh, this is frozen.
Snow glows white on the mountain tonight, not a footprint to be seen. A kingdom of ice.
And this is what won the Oscar, right?
Yes, as it should have. Though we were afraid Bono was going to get it.
I got to admit, I thought it was a really good performance by you two.
Her or Bono? Oh, Bono. Yeah, I mean, it was, but...
And I never heard the song. I never, ever heard the song before.
That'll be later, too.
You know, the song for her, I haven't seen her... I'm kind of freaked out about seeing a movie about a guy who falls in love with his operating system.
Oh, yeah. Her. Gosh.
That's just...
It seems a little too far.
That might be too meta. It might be too meta for me, but I'll give it a try. But you were saying there's a statistic that you take the 9 best picture... Turn this off already.
Oh, but it's such a good song. You can't take yourself seriously?
It's more about my respect level for you than anything else. And I just want to move on with it. There comes a moment where you got to... There's a moment where you have to actually do the show, and then a moment where you get to fall back into the fantasy land. All right? And you get to put on a dress and just prance. You know? For me, that's a little bit after midnight. Just me. I forgot what I was going to ask. Oh, there's a statistic.
Yeah.
That you take the nine films for Best Picture, and there's a tremendous amount of America that never saw them.
Yeah.
What is that number? Like, is there a...
I think it's most Americans have only seen one out of the nine films. I'm not sure what the actual number is, but that's... They're saying... let me see if I can find it.
I just find it interesting that you've got the... I mean, all right, I can see a movie like Philomena. Maybe not everybody saw. Nebraska is a kind of a peculiar film. Captain Phillips? American Hustle? Gravity? Hasn't everybody and their mother seen Gravity? By the way, it wins seven awards. It wins Best Director, but nothing for Sandra Bullock and nothing for Best Picture, 12 Years a Slave winning Best Picture. And I have a question. The Terrence Winter? Is that his name? Best Adapted Screenplay, right? For 12 Years a Slave. Who? I forget his name. I have it right here. I know I have. Adapted Screenplay. John Ridley. I'm sorry. John Ridley was the winner there, not Terrence Winter. I apologize. Terrence Winter wrote Wolf of Wall Street. He did not, if I'm correct, in his thank you, say anything about the director of the movie. There seemed to be some terseness. When he came down, he didn't even shake the director's hand. I don't know if there's a fight there or not. And there's a photo of everybody from 12 Years a Slave. And here it is from HollywoodReporter.com. I'll throw that in the chat room there, Tony Katz, tonight. And boom, there it is. And there's a photo. He is all the way in the back. Now, he had won his award, so maybe he had to come out as opposed to walking up with everybody. He does not look happy to be there at all. Now, maybe it's just the way the picture caught him, but I take the fact that he won, didn't say anything that I remember about the director, didn't shake his hand on the way down to accept his award. I didn't know if there was a fight there or not, and I thought that was interesting. I just don't know if there's some kind of was there a power struggle? Was there a tussle? Was there a thing? I'd have no idea. But 12 Years a Slave, which I am told is also, I have not seen a single movie this year. I've been a little busy. I have so many. I have seen more movies in the past 2 months than I have seen all of last year, and one of them was the Lego Movie, which clearly is Movie of the Year. If you haven't seen Lego Movie, it is officially the Movie of the Year. Here was another what the chat room thinks was one of the great moments of the Oscars. It was Bill Murray with his shout-out to Harold Ramis, if you've got that page.
I do.
If you have that. If I could set it up any better than I just did. If I can set that up better for you, I will do that.
But I just had it just switched on me.
Why? Why?
I don't know.
It's racist.
Hang on.
It's not even right. What happens? Like when I bring it, when I bring it perfect, perfect, and then nothing. All
right,
play it.
Right, here we go.
We forgot one. Harold Ramis for Caddyshack, Ghostbusters, and Groundhog Day.
Made people very, very happy. Very happy to see that shout out. Absolutely did for me. I can't say that there were any surprises at the Oscars. I can't say, oh, I can't believe so and so won. I think the biggest surprise was Matthew McConaughey's speech. I think it really took a lot of people, took their breath away. One of the big things noticed, Woody Allen, his movie Blue Jasmine won for Best Actress, Cate Blanchett. And when she mentioned Woody Allen, he got applause. Woody Allen, of course, has been in the news. His now grown daughter that he had with Mia Farrow accusing him basically of rape and people saying it's a confusing subject. Clearly, Woody Allen has a thing for young girls. We know this regarding Sun Yi. I am a guy who I own Woody Allen books. I consider Annie Hall to be one of the all-time classics. I respect the way he came up as a writer with Sid Caesar and what he did there. I have a lot of respect for those guys in those early days of comedy writing and what it must have been like to be in one of those rooms around that you're surrounded by Carl Reiner and Mel Brooks and Sid Caesar and all these guys. It must have been just an amazing experience. I would love just 10 minutes with Brooks and Reiner. Good Lord. But that is a man of controversy, and that is a man who clearly doesn't have what I would consider to be his head aligned properly. He's got a sickness within him. Period. If you like small children, you've got a sickness within you. I don't have to apologize for that. You wanna yell at me, Tony at WIBC.com, email me. Like I'm gonna pay attention. But he got applause. When Matthew McConaughey talks about first and foremost thanking God, he got less applause than child sex lover Woody Allen. And that's a mind scramble. What is Hollywood telling us? And why is it so shocking that Matthew McConaughey should start by thanking God, as if it's somehow not allowed in Hollywood? How? Oh, talking about the God again. Why not be thankful? As I have said more than once, not big into proselytizing, folks. It's not something I enjoy hearing. It's not something I enjoy being around. And also, I will say that I agree that's not something I don't specifically understand. Not being Christian. I get that. It's not for me, and it could be just, you know, it's not what I'm familiar with, ergo, it's not something I enjoy. But I don't think he was doing that. This is a moment where, if you're an actor, you certainly worked hard for this, right? He's a guy who in this role, like the role, not like the role, put himself at a lot of physical risk in terms of losing that much weight. He didn't put himself at risk like a soldier puts himself at risk, or a cop puts himself at risk, but certainly was willing to do the work to make the role as authentic as he could. Isn't that what an actor is supposed to do? I don't think we should shame actors for that. And he was thankful. So he said so. What's wrong with saying so? Is Hollywood really a place? I mean, the answer is yes. That's the sick part. Is Hollywood really a place where if you thank God, you are you're weird? Being thankful for what you have, for what you've received, for what you were able to accomplish? You think that there are very few in Hollywood where it just comes to them. Listen, I live in this town. I live in Los Angeles. I know actors who are still working every single day, struggling to try and get that opportunity. Every single day, trying to get that break. You don't think they'll be thankful if and when it comes? Because there's no guarantee that it'll come. They have a passion, they have a desire, and they want to go out and fulfill that desire. And by the way, there are conservatives in Hollywood. At least we can say that clearly now. I don't know his politics, right? Maybe I shouldn't say conservatives. Maybe that's not the right way to use the word. But there's certainly someone in Hollywood, and probably more than one in Hollywood, who know that when good things happen, you're supposed to be thankful. But when Hollywood will give Woody Allen more applause than a guy thanking God for his good fortune, Hollywood should take note that we took note. They really should take a little bit of stock in that, because it says something about their character and the lack thereof. More when we return. This is Tony Katz tonight.
The passion.
Kicks in the will at a two-hand flare.
The cry.
4 minutes.
Up the three and hut!
The cream and crimson. The Hoosiers take on Nebraska Wednesday. Coverage begins at 6. IU plays here. 93 WIBC.
Oh, my God. Susie, is that you?
Hey, Bob.
You look so skinny. Did you have bariatric surgery?
No, I didn't.
Liposuction?
No.
Then how did you lose all that weight?
I lost it thanks to Bistrictin.
Hi, I'm Alan Smith, creator of the Bistrictin weight control system, and I lost 51 pounds and 6 inches without even really trying. No, it's not another diet pill or anything you've ever tried before. It's so easy. Just drink the delicious tasting complex, and it expands in your stomach over 50 times, forcing you to eat substantially less food without ever feeling hungry. Bistrictin is safe,
right,
with clinically proven ingredients that help you lose weight fast. No surgery, no liposuction, and no wacky diet pills. Call right now and try it risk-free for 30 days, so you either lose weight or it's free. But you need to call now for this special limited-time risk-free offer. Call 800-481-9808. That's 800-481-9808. 800-481-9808.
Bodies of all shapes and sizes, bending, stretching, turning, twisting, motion, suspense, chaos. Korish Dance Company comes to the Tarkington at the Center for the Performing Arts for two nights of turbocharged dance on March 14th and 15th. Beautiful bodies, breathtaking movement, artistic athleticism. An evening of repertoire that combines ballet, modern, and jazz in an unforgettable evening of dance. The evening's highlight, Ravel's Bolero. You've heard Ravel's most celebrated musical composition. Now you can see the piece come to life as Koresh Dance Company converts music into passion. Live at the Tarkington. Tickets at thecenterpresents.org or call 843-3800. Sponsored by St. Vincent Health. Be at the center of it all.
Disclaimers at cnctaxprogram.com. If the IRS claims you owe back taxes, you could qualify for a special tax program, and you won't make any payments to the IRS. That's right, I said if you qualify for the CNC tax
program, minute and a half,
you won't make any payments to the IRS while in this program. Get ready to write down the most important number you may ever need to finally end your IRS nightmare. This toll-free number should only be used
fantastic,
if you can't afford to pay any money to the IRS. Call 800-652-2595 now to see if you qualify for the CNC tax program. Once you're accepted, the IRS must stop all collection activities against you. No more threatening phone calls, no wage garnishments or bank levies, and no more monthly payments to the IRS. Just call 800-652-2595 now to find out if you qualify for the CNC tax program. You won't make any payments to the IRS while in this program. Call 800-652-2595 now. That's 800-652-2595. 800-652-2595. Again, 800-652-2595.
The biggest goal for me, it would be to continue to travel.
To do as well as I can do with my job.
I'm getting ready to retire, and I'm really looking forward to it. Getting healthy.
I would love to visit Australia. Never been to Australia.
Live well, chase your dreams, and along the way, make the decision to become an organ donor so you can give someone else the chance to chase their dreams, too. Learn more at DonateLifeIndiana.org. Brought to you by the Indiana Broadcasters Association and this station.
Refresh yourself with an abundance of spring plant life and color inside the Indiana Flower and Patio Show, March 8th through the 16th. State Fairgrounds, IndianaFlowerAndPatioShow.com.
To talk to Tony Katz, call 800-571-9422 or 239-9393. This is Tony Katz Tonight.
All right, all right, all right.
You're in.
I do love the all right, all right, all right.
The sea wants to kiss the gold.
Never heard this song before. It was good. It was good. I'll give you this. The best story from the Oscars not told is a story about America. And I didn't know the story until a couple hours ago. So everyone saw, by the way, the reason that you pay attention to culture, sometimes some things matriculate to the top. That's the right use of the word, right? I'm going to say it is. It's a good song. Even though, you know, hitting that falsetto there. You saw, if you watched the Oscars, you saw the pizza, right? There was the whole thing with the pizza delivery, and it was a gag on gag. Everybody knew it was coming, that the pizza would show up. I think she did a good job with the, I'm out of money, so, you know, raising money for it and putting that all together. Well, she had on today on her show, Ellen hosted the Oscars. Did you like the gag, by the way, Paige? Did you think it was a good gag with the pizza?
I think that part got a little slow, but the best part was when she started wanting the money and she called out to, like, Harvey Weinstein.
Right. Just a billion people watching. Give what you think is right.
Right. I loved that part.
Yeah, and that's when she's at her best, which is just this deadpan kind of stuff. And she didn't do enough of that, as far as I'm concerned. But she has on her show the pizza delivery guy today. because she raised this money and she wanted to give him the tip, right? And what was it like showing up at the Oscars and had we set you up and the whole thing? And you said that you needed pizzas for, you know, the writers or whatever. And then all of a sudden you're like, follow me, and you bring me out on stage. And I didn't know what was happening. It was crazy. And I gave pizza to Julia Roberts, and, you know, oh, what a crush I have on Julia Roberts. And you watch this video, which, you know, Hollywood Reporter has it. You learn the story of this guy. The guy's name is Edgar. Why is this important? I'll tell you gladly. His name is Edgar. And the pizzeria, which is here in L.A., I've been to one, not specifically the one that delivered, but I've been to one, Big Mama and Papa's Pizza. They won huge. Turns out he doesn't just work there. He owns the franchise that made the pizzas, and he owns it with his brother. And what he said was about the, it came out as he's giving the pizza to Julia Roberts, is one of his favorite stars. And he writes, and he said to her, she was like a woman in my dreams. I was always watching her movies back in Moscow. Back in Moscow. You look at him, he's a young guy. He looks like he's in his 20s, maybe his early 30s. And when you see him on the show, he is extremely well put together. He was composed. He had a good look to him, like somebody could use him in a movie. You know, we've learned a lot from the media culture, how to be media savvy and media ready at a moment's notice. The story is that this guy is Russian, clearly came to America, opened a business, ta-da. It's a fantastic story. Like, now I want to know everything about this guy. When did he come over? Because when he's talking, you're like, wow, there's definitely an accent there. Russian, when you saw him on the screen there during the Oscars, I would not have predicted in any way, shape, or form he was Russian. Now you want to know how he got here. How did he get the business? How long has he had the business? Does he own the whole the franchise, or just does he own the whole company, or just this one franchise? Do you want to know everything about him? Because isn't this very American dream? A story that you would not know if you weren't watching. Why the hell is Tony Katz talking about the Oscars for an hour? For the same reason that I wrote about why people are totally crazed if they're upset with an Ellen selfie and somehow making it political. The conversation about culture war isn't one about talking about culture. It's about being involved in culture, and then most importantly, what it is can be learned from culture. If you didn't watch, you would have let slip by that the guy who delivered the pizzas owns the franchise and is from Russia, now lives in the U.S. How did it happen? Isn't that the American dream story that we should be talking about everywhere? Why in the world would I let that slip through my fingers? Doesn't make any sense to me. If the left is going to get in hysterics because a photo of Ellen and some actors is going to get more retweets than a Barack Obama photo, and Barack Obama supporters are enraged by this, shouldn't we just point and laugh at their level of unhinged, deranged madness? Why would we counter that? What's the point? Can't you just let certain things be? Isn't there a moment that something matters and something doesn't? Something is worth fighting for and something is just a thing? It's just there? It doesn't require a level of anger that you reserve for Obamacare or attack on the Second Amendment or an attack on your First Amendment rights? It's a photo. You really got to find, well, we'll show them. Show them what? For the people who don't understand where I stand in this culture fight, I don't want to be someone talking about the actors in that photo. I want people who think like, quote unquote, us in the photo. And then winning, and then having speeches, some ways like Matthew McConaughey, maybe differently. Not everyone has to have the religious tenor that his had, or belief tenor, I should say, if not religious. It could be about something else. Jared Leto reminding us that there's something happening in Ukraine and something happening in Venezuela. Just a reminder. Reminders that the Obama administration certainly doesn't want you to think of, nor the mainstream press. Anybody talking about Venezuela these days? Anybody going to admit that Chavez was a complete and total thug and failure? That Sean Penn, who was his best friend, is a complete and total fool? Except for the fact that he can really get some women. I mean, it's stunning, my friends. It is stunning. And that Venezuela now is falling into despair. People are going to suffer. It's going to get uglier. Is that not worth noting in the mainstream press? I've got Jared Leto to notice it. Or should I just be upset that he did a movie where he was in drag? Should that be the top line story? The culture war can be won when you learn how to fight and you're willing to focus on the things of value and let go the madness. Can't seem to find enough people to let go of the madness. When we return, the most intriguing story in Indiana I have heard ever. This is Tony Katz Tonight.
Do you remember what you looked like and felt like just 9 years ago?
I really do.
Hi, this is Denny Smith. And 9 years ago, I was
guys, we'll
shape,
be right back.
Feeling
right
sluggish and not very happy with my general state of health. An old friend recommended I try Exercise Inc. to try a different type of exercising that only took 20 minutes a week. Truthfully, I thought my friend was full of it, but here I am 9 years later still doing that 20 minutes a week and I've never felt better. You ought to try it. And just know that it'll be the toughest 20 minutes of your life. You'll be doing 5 or 6 specific exercises that last less than 3 minutes on custom machines, and you'll come out of those slow cadence exercises pretty much exhausted. But don't worry, you recover really quickly and you won't believe how much better you'll feel. And you'll find yourself so much healthier and better shape each and every week. Just call them. It's Exercise, Inc., and they're in 3 different locations, in Avon, in Brownsburg, and in Zionsville. All of them for you. 873-5700. That's 873-5700 or exerciseinc.com.
Are you looking for a church where you can put work clothes on your faith?
Pastor John Gable of Tabernacle Presbyterian Church.
Whether it's serving food at the soup kitchen, tutoring and mentoring an elementary school child, or showing boys and girls the love of Christ on our sports field. TAB is a place where we actually live out the message of the gospel, not just on Sunday morning, but throughout the week. At TAB, we don't just talk about our faith, we do it. And not just because these are the right things to do. We do them because Jesus instructs us to love God and serve our neighbors. What about you? Are you ready to put work clothes on your faith? Find out how you can fit in at tabpres.org.
Tabernacle Presbyterian Church, 34th Street and Central Avenue in Indianapolis, invites you to worship Sunday morning at 8, 9, or 11. If you can't make it in person, tune in to Sunday with Tab, Sunday mornings at 6:30 on WIBC. To learn more about Tab, visit us at tabpres.org.
Indianapolis, purchase or refinance, FHA, VA, conventional, or USDA. Go to MeridianMortgageSolutions.net for rates starting in the threes. Little to no out-of-pocket closing costs, and we can have your loan closed in as little as 14 days. Right now, we're offering a $500 credit for all first-time homebuyers. If you have perfect or even less than perfect credit, call Meridian Mortgage Solutions now at 317-968-9500 or apply online at MeridianMortgageSolutions.net.
All loans and rates are subject to credit approval. Programs and rates are subject to change. Additional terms and conditions apply. Equal housing lender. See lender for restrictions and details. NMLS number 2975.
This hour, powered by the Bill Estes Ford Cash for Junkers sale. From the Plumbing, Heating, Paramedic Studios.
This is Central Indiana's news, weather, and traffic station.
93 WIBC, Indianapolis.
Fox News Radio, I'm Bill Vitka. More troops, more ships, more aircraft. The provisional government in Kiev says 16,000 Russian troops now occupy strategic positions in the breakaway region. Moscow seizing border posts and blockading 2 Ukrainian warships and ordering them to surrender or be seized. That deadline has passed without word of anything happening. While the U.S. and Europe threaten diplomatic and economic retaliation, Moscow says it has every right to deploy its troops.
It justifies its troop movements in autonomous Crimea on two grounds: protecting its majority ethnic Russian population and its Black Sea fleet from what it calls an illegal coup.
I repeat, this is a matter of defending our citizens and our compatriots.
With Moscow flexing both military and rhetorical muscles, world leaders will be hoping their united diplomatic firewall is tough enough to force a change of direction.
Robert Nesbitt of Fox Sister Network Sky News. In Montana, the woman who was rescued after an avalanche destroyed her house in Missoula has died. Meanwhile, police will meet with prosecutors to consider whether a snowboarder who allegedly triggered the avalanche should face criminal penalties. A group of Vietnam veterans is suing the military, saying that instead of other than honorable discharge, the real issue was post-traumatic stress.
A less than honorable discharge is a lifetime scar.
Conley Monk of New Haven is one of them. When he got back from the 3rd Marine Division from Nam, he said he couldn't get a job and couldn't go to school on the GI Bill.
This discharge prohibits veterans from being a productive citizen.
While vets can apply to get their discharge upgrade, they're usually turned down. The lawsuit said it's systematic refusal. No comment so far from the Pentagon. The annual ranking of the biggest of the world's billionaires finds Bill Gates of Microsoft, again, wearing the crown. His net worth is estimated at $76 billion. Number two on the list, Mexico's Carlos Slim, $72 million. You're listening to Fox News Radio, fair and balanced.
Real experience, real insight.
We're following this explosive story.
Nothing gets by Greta. Then.
This is all BS. What was that all about?
There's no spin and no question. O'Reilly dominates. Plus, smart, sharp, and cutting edge.
It's the news of the day, but with a little heat.
Megan delivers. And Sean seals the deal with fearless talk.
What part of that are you understanding?
Most watched, most trusted, Fox News Channel.
There's more to Fox News Radio than meets the ear. Go behind the headlines and join the conversation on the hottest stories of the day on the Fox News Radio Facebook page. Be a part of the Fox News Radio Facebook fan community. Post comments and tell us your opinions. See behind-the-scenes photos and videos and post your reactions to the stories that matter to you. Click the like button on Facebook and connect with breaking news and features like Fox in the Fast Lane, House Call for Help, and more. Go to Facebook.com/Fox News Radio.
Hey, Daisy, I know I told you about how Zero Res came to clean my carpets a few weeks ago and how the entire experience was just a big, giant pile of awesome sauce, but did I mention that the floors still look great? They put magical stain guard stuff on them, too.
I know, Mach. I'm dying for them to come back out and do more rooms in my house. The difference between the tile flooring that they cleaned and the flooring that they haven't yet is just amazing, even though I'm obsessive about cleaning my floors.
It's because Zero Res uses what they call empowered water, which is like powerful hocus-pocus magic that cleans without soap, detergent, or surfactant. It's high tech and it works.
And they're running a special where you get three rooms and a hallway Zero Resified starting at just $129.
Best deal ever.
Now that I know that they don't just clean carpets and tile, but almost every other surface you can think of, I have a huge list of stuff I want them to clean.
You guys have to call them and see for yourself. It's 317-388-5141.
That's 317-388-5141 or visit them at zeroresindy.com. Spelled backwards or forwards, it's the right way to clean.
I'm Alex Brown in the 93 WIBC 24-hour news center. In a criminal complaint filed in federal court in Columbus, Ohio, Indiana National Guardsman Andrew Boguslawski of Moores Hill, Indiana, is accused of illegal possession of unregistered destructive devices. After the bombs were found in his van, Boguslawski was arrested by Ohio State troopers who had pulled him over for speeding on Interstate 70. An Associated Press report points to former State Republican Party Chairman Jim Kittle, but House Speaker Brian Bosma refuses to name names. Bosma still says only that opponents of the same-sex marriage amendment offered him unlimited campaign funding to make the amendment go away and also offered a would-be primary challenger a $500,000 contribution to enter the race.
This has been most unusual and completely out of line on this issue from the start, really only from one side throughout this year.
Bosma will be unopposed in both the primary and the general election. Metro Police say 36-year-old Timothy Guilfoy told them the underage female in his truck with him was one of his students at Greenwood High School and that they were having sex.
Yes, they were. They were having sex.
Guilfoy now faces two preliminary counts of child seduction.
Teacher.
Greenwood Community Schools confirmed that he has resigned.
Hoosiers filed more than 15,000 complaints with the state's attorney general during 2013. Attorney General Greg Zeller said complaints against retail stores and home contractors were among the fastest growing categories. Zeller is hosting an event Thursday featuring consumer protection groups and law enforcement agencies about topics relating to National Consumer Protection Week. You're up to date. Get local news on demand at WIBC.com. Now here's the forecast from the American Standard Heating Weather Center.
Very cold, close to record cold by morning. The record 2 above, forecasted low 4 degrees. Tuesday afternoon, partly sunny, a high of 27, 34 with increasing clouds Wednesday. I'm RTV6 meteorologist Kevin Gregory.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Tony Katz tonight.
All right, all right, all right.
You're it.
So, a little breaking news. Medea Benjamin of Code Pink is in jail in Cairo. That just broke just a few moments ago. The far leftist group, the same group that's always on the side of the enemy as opposed to America, in jail, according to Gateway pundit, the great Jim Hoft. Photos of her cell. We'll keep you updated as that one progresses. Tony Katz tonight, a pleasure to be with all of you. 317-239-9393. Toll free, 800-571-9422. Online, TonyKatz.com. This story is fantastic because it literally comes out of House of Cards, but it's happening in Indiana. House Speaker Brian Bozma, this is from Eric Berman and Ray Steele at their WIBC.com. House Speaker Brian Bozma says opponents of the state's ban on same-sex marriage offered someone campaign money to challenge him in a primary, but two Republican Party officials say that that's the first they've heard of the claim. Listen to this. I haven't had any conversations with anyone in regards to a primary challenge for Speaker Bozma, said Kyle Walker, chairman of the Marion County Republican Party. Bozma's House district covers parts of Marion and Hamilton counties, and he is unopposed in both the primary and general elections this year. I haven't heard anything, said Hamilton County GOP chair Peter, what's his last name? Emma? E-M-I-G-A? E-M-I-G-H, I should say. M-I? I don't know how you pronounce his last name. An email response to questions about Bozma's claim. Bozma made the allegation 10 days ago during a meeting with reporters, as well as claiming he was twice offered unlimited campaign funds if he would shut down the marriage amendment known as HJR3 without a vote. Bozma refused to say who made the offer or who his alleged primary challenger would be. The Associated Press reports that the would-be donor was former state party Republican chair Jim Kittle, an opponent of HJR3. Bozma calls the offers of campaign funds most unusual and completely out of line. Tell me that's not a storyline from House of Cards. That's exactly where it comes from, Paige. This isn't, make any sense. Yeah, so the shadowy figure had offered me a whole bunch of money if I would drop the legislation.
In a position in the cabinet.
He would only meet in the parking lot. It's crazy. And then, you know, I don't want to give any spoilers to anything that's happened at House of Cards, so I won't do that because I'm not done yet. I'm not done with season two.
So good.
But I'm getting there. I don't have as much free time as you in a day.
Oh, yes, because I have so much free time.
So you've got this job, and you've got another job, and you've got a baby, and, yeah, you've got nothing but free time. Clearly,
another job on top of that.
Clearly, you have more free time than me. I've been unable to finish the series. So,
We were snowed in yesterday.
That's the problem with California. No snow days.
Right.
No snow days. There was
at a certain point.
It was so funny. There was I was having a cigar with a friend yesterday. All of a sudden, somebody comes out of the house and is like, did you feel anything? And I'm like, what did we miss? There was an earthquake. We missed it. When it's like a 2.8, which is non-existent.
That's nothing.
You know, all you hear, like I heard something, like I heard the crack, like a crack of a bat, which sometimes you can hear. But I didn't feel anything whatsoever. It's and when you don't know if you're feeling it or not, look up at a chandelier. If the chandelier's moving, you're moving. But there hasn't been a big earthquake in California in a while.
Since 94, right?
Well, wait. So that's the Northridge quake, right?
Right.
That's the one that destroyed everything. And
that
I
knocked out power in Idaho.
Oh, it was insane. I mean, what it did to this town. You know, to parts of I live in the valley, so that's not too far away. What it did to the valley, I mean, absolutely destructive. But it's due. I've been here 5 years, and the first year I was here, there was an earthquake. My then business partner, we were at I forget where we were. We were working at desks, and we were working in somebody's office until we had our own, and. I don't think we even got – that's not the point of the story. We're working at these desks, and things start moving. It's my first earthquake. I'm like, what the – and he's like, don't worry about it. And then it keeps going. He goes, okay, this is a big one. Get under the desk. So I got under the desk. I don't know. I still don't know if he was screwing with me, but things moved. I mean, it wobbled. It was – your first experience with an earthquake is something else. But this is I can say this, that the 2.8 was nothing. I didn't feel anything at all. Not a thing. I don't even know how I got into earthquakes. Let's go back to Indiana. The story is crazy. Like, I have a hard time believing the story. And that there's, you know, it's possibly this guy or it's possibly that guy. I mean, I don't know what to – I know that people didn't want – the amendment, because they didn't want to deal with the issues. Many of them other people did want the amendment. But am I going to believe now that there was a payola conversation? You take care of this, and we get you some cat? Really? It comes directly out of movies. And I want to know, like, I want to speak to Bosma. Who was it? Why would you say it happened? And maybe I don't have the full story. Like, maybe I only have part of the story, and I need more. Like, I need Berman or Steele on. Right? You're claiming that somebody offered you unlimited money twice, not once, but twice. Who was it? Why not tell me who? Don't tell me you were offered and then you're the one above it all. No, sir. No. Who was it? I am not interested in going through a whodunit. This isn't like some murder mystery train ride where you got to go from car to car in order to figure out who it was. You know, I'm not interested in playing a game of Clue with you. I don't know who had the candlestick, and I don't care. Just tell me who did this. Who offered you the money? Why wouldn't you tell me? Why would you put the story out there? You call it most unusual and completely out of line. Well, we think it's most unusual. We think it's completely out of line. Who was it? Don't you want to know, Paige?
Yes.
Like, it's just a... It's so weird. It's so flat out peculiar. And it's not only flat out peculiar as a story, it's peculiar as how it's being released. Why would you only tell that part of it? Why wouldn't you let us know who it was? Why isn't there an accusation to be made? Aren't there charges that could be brought up? Did you ever take any money from them before, sir? Do you know the person? Have you ever had coffee with the person? Did they ever pay for dinner? Have they ever talked to you about anything that interests them politically? I mean, there are questions. And when you don't tell us who it is, there are more questions. That's the part that blows my mind. Why would you bring it up unless there was a purpose to bring it up? And then you get all Frank Underwood on the thing. And you're like, well, he's trying to apply pressure to someone. Well, who's he trying to apply pressure to? And is it someone who can provide something if pressure was applied? And maybe I can provide a different kind of pressure, or I can relieve their pressure and apply my own pressure and therefore get them to work for me or give me unlimited campaign funds. My goodness, this is the big backroom dealing of Indiana politics. Unless I don't think it's that big. I don't think it's that big backroom dealings. But it is curious. I am a curious fellow. I've been spending more and more time learning about Indiana politics. trying to understand what's going on, really see where the people are at. I'm very excited about this town hall that WIBC is doing with ADT and others at the end of March. I'll give you all the information after the break. I'm coming out for it. I think it's going to be great. I'm very much looking forward to it. The spate of murders when I was there filling in for the morning show, there was another one. There have been some other issues. What's happening? What's going on? To this whole idea that, you know, it's gang on gang crime or people who know each other. Listen, I'm okay with them taking each other out. The problem is that stuff doesn't usually stay with just them. Sometimes it leads to stray bullets. I need to understand what's happening, because when it goes from people knowing each other to people being affected outside that circle, that's when we all have a real problem. We've got much more ahead. This is Tony Katz tonight.
This was 08.
Well, and they've had all those break-ins.
Putin to invade Ukraine next.
Yes.
This was 2012.
When you were asked what's...
Which scares the crap out of me as a woman home alone with my baby.
The Cold War has been over for 20 years.
This is now.
We are now.
By the way, I don't understand.
She seems so long ago.
I don't understand your message there.
Because you said Jim Hoft. So I said Jimmy.
News breaks on the level.
We used to call him Jimmy Hoft.
WIBC at WIBC.com.
It's a huge problem and big concern.
In fact, he we had Chris Wallace on our airways, and he got pulled over for talking on his cell phone, and we sent it to Jim to get it out there.
Protect your company's reputation and the data you hold confidential.
Ah, okay.
Technology Recyclers is your solution. Technology Recyclers.
That was honestly probably one of the funniest days in broadcasting for me.
They destroy them and recycle the shredded materials. They provide fast, efficient, 100% certified and licensed peace of mind to you, to your company's reputation. Their professional drivers will pick up, transport, and shred it all absolutely free. Technology Recyclers.
I would hate to be the reporter that drew the short straw to go to the Ukraine.
Schools, solid waste districts.
And somebody was thrilled to go.
Demanding a peace of mind that their confidential data is destroyed, yet wanting to recycle. Call Technology Recyclers at 1-800-237-3887 or visit tech-recyclers.com.
If you need reliable, high-quality video production, look no further than PrimeImageMedia.com. PrimeImageMedia.com provides promotional videos, training videos, and conference and event coverage nationwide. Get a high-quality, consistent look to your corporate videos with the most reliable video company in the country. Visit PrimeImageMedia.com today to learn more. Mention Tony Katz and get 10% off your first production. That's PrimeImageMedia.com. PrimeImageMedia.com.
You know the quality of education at public schools
2 minutes.
Is not what it should be. The educational system in the United States is in a major crisis. Your child deserves better. Welcome to American High School, a fully accredited private online school for grades 6 to 12, offering excellent education with high moral standards. If you're a parent concerned about bullying, drugs, and overcrowding in public schools, American High School Online is your answer. You'll have access to our counselors and certified teachers. Our graduates receive a high school diploma, not a GED, and the ability to attend the college of their choice. Spaces are limited and fill up fast, so call now for free enrollment information. Financial aid is available. Call now, 888-312-9305. That's 888-312-9305, or visit AmericanHighSchool.tv. Don't let your child get any further behind. Call now, 888-312-9305. That's 888-312-9305.
Now during Menards Kitchen and Bath Sale, it's the perfect time to update your home. Save big
1 minute.
Fantastic selection of cabinets, sinks, faucets, flooring, plus much more. Complete your bath remodel with a new toilet by Elger. Complete models include everything you need in one box. The tall, elongated Belmont-style toilet by Elger is on sale for just
$1.
Check out this and many more great deals. Now during Menards Kitchen and Bath Sale.
Save big money at Menards.
If you're worried about paying your mortgage, here's some good news. The federal government's Making Home Affordable program has been extended. Also, there are new opportunities for more struggling homeowners to qualify. If you're having trouble paying your mortgage, additional help is available. Get mortgage relief today. Visit makinghomeaffordable.gov or call 888-995-HOPE. That's makinghomeaffordable.gov or call 888-995-HOPE.
I'm Gary Dick. Inside Indiana Business Radio provides the breaking news you need to get ahead. Indiana's business news leader, weekdays at 6:40 a.m. and 5:35
p.m. All right.
WIBC.
To talk to Tony Katz, call 800-571-9422 or 239-9393. This is Tony Katz Tonight.
You're in.
I think it's a good song, too. So the chat room is reminding me that the New Madrid fault line is way more dangerous than the San Andreas. Just one more reason to move to Indianapolis. Am I right?
You can teach us all how to deal, except I'll know, but you can teach the rest how to deal with an earthquake.
Mr. Fastbucks is totally right that nothing really in the Midwest, I believe he's right, I should say, is built to any kind of proper seismic standard.
No.
That, you know, you're talking about some major devastation. I'm looking at some maps here, which shows there was the fault there in New Madrid in 1895. It was a 6.8 in all of the states it affected. And then what happened in 1994 in California? Well, it affected less states because the ocean's right there. But it's not fun to think about. It's never fun to think about. But how many people really in Indianapolis go through their day like, you know, if there's an earthquake here, we're all done? How many people think about earthquakes?
Probably not many, because I mean, a tornado is more likely than an earthquake, you would think.
I would think so as well. I would clearly think so as well. Why would I not? Now, how many tornadoes really take place? Like, really?
Since I've been here, there have been, well, I should say in the Midwest, and that includes St. Louis, I've been around for quite a few.
What just happened?
That's a hiccup.
Did you sit on something?
No, I hiccup. I told you, I have hiccups.
Is there a hedgehog that no longer exists? What the? Well, you really do have the hiccups. Oh, that's adorable.
I wasn't kidding.
That's adorable. Let's just wait for the next one. Everyone be quiet. Shh, shh, shh.
Well, now it's going to take a while.
Wait, where is it? It's going to be there any second.
But no,
this is incredible radio. Now wait, we got to wait for the hiccup. Come on.
Can I just say though, I was so uncomfortable with the first. There it is. The first tornado that I was in, or warning for St. Louis, because I don't know what to do for a tornado. I know what to do for an earthquake, but not a tornado.
I mean. The thing that is so frightening for me about a tornado is how quickly it happens. The only time I've been around tornadoes, I was in Kansas I was in Hutchinson, Kansas for a tea party event a few years back. Oh, that is adorable. You can hear you trying to suppress the hiccup. Oh, good Lord. It sounds like a baby burping. It is just ridiculous. And there was a tornado coming from two different sides. And just, I was staying at someone's house and I was on their deck, couldn't stand upright. I'd never felt winds like that before in my life. It's the come upon you so fast. That's the part that freaks me out. Like, that's flat out frightening. But I guess it must be, you know, you get to a level of standard procedure of everybody in the basement. Everyone, let's go. Wherever you are, everyone in the basement. I mean, that's just a thing. That's where you live. That's what you deal with. Go ahead.
Oh, sorry. No. I was going to say, except a lot of people don't go into the basement. Like, that's the thing I found so interesting in St. Louis is that there was a whole bunch of people. Like, the minute the sirens went off, the first one, I was down in the basement. I was, like, huddled in a corner. And my husband's like, okay. And everyone else that I talked to later, I was like, oh, no, we go check outside and see where it is, you know, if it's even really there, and then we go in the basement. I was like, that sounds safe.
Seriously, you're talking about such a serious subject, but all I can hear are the hiccups, and I'm crying.
Sorry.
Oh, dear God.
I'll be quiet from here on out.
No. Please speak more. So there are some people who do that. Listen, there are some people who, when there's a hurricane, I used to live in Tampa Bay. They want to know what's going on. They're not leaving. They're not, you know, they'll board up their house a little bit, but they're like, whatever, I'm staying. people stay through disasters all the time up and down the Eastern Seaboard. I mean, that's that some people, they just don't think it's ever going to be that bad. Everyone's just reporting it as bad because that's what they do. I don't think that's generally the case with something that can pick up tractor trailers and throw them through your house. That's my problem. But I guess everywhere you go, I've never lived anywhere that was immune. Right? New Jersey wasn't immune. And
everywhere has their thing.
Right. No, I agree. Everywhere has their thing. Let me go to Chuck on line two there. Chuck, welcome to Tony Katz Tonight. What's up there, my friend?
Yes, Tony, I was in the 94 earthquake and sitting in Rialto and lived right on the San Andreas fault, which comes down through Lytle Creek and down into San Bernardino Rialto area.
Sure, absolutely.
And I've seen that road at 66, which is Foothill Boulevard, go up and down like a darn
yeah, just wave like a slinky in it with a kid.
Yeah, but I would rather be in an earthquake than in a tornado, and I've been in them here.
Why is that?
Well, tornadoes disastrous, so much so it'll take a house, a brick home, and cut it in half. And it looked like a dollhouse. You can see all the furniture. I've seen that here. And it's terrible. I grew up in this area, but I lived out there in California 35 years. And I'll tell you.
So you'll take an earthquake over a tornado?
No, don't. I would rather be in one. If I had my choice, I would rather be in an earthquake
over a tornado. Right? You'd rather an earthquake over a tornado. I we're now taking a poll. What would you rather take, earthquake or tornado? I appreciate it. David, line one, welcome to Tony Katz Tonight. Earthquake or tornado, my friend?
Well, I'd rather be in a tornado with a noise type hidey hole like they used to have in North Vietnam when our bombers had come over. It's a culvert you stick in the ground vertically and bury it and leave the top open and put 2x4s as a lid. And you hide in it, and all the tornado goes across the top and leaves you unturned.
Okay, but can't I just use my basement?
Pardon?
Can't I just use the basement?
Yeah, but okay. If you don't have a basement.
Well, if you don't have a basement, you better have something. You better have a plan B. I agree.
That's the plan B.
And I think a hole in the ground is a fine plan B. Because either way, you're going in a hole in the ground. You know, I'm totally with you. But what did you want to say?
That's it.
Well, I appreciate it.
Hidey hole.
Well, then hidey hole it is. Hidey hole it is, my friends. I appreciate that, David. Thank you so much. I didn't even know that people still use the term hidey hole. I didn't know that was still a thing. Nobody tells me anything.
I didn't know it was a term at all.
You didn't know it was a term? Oh, everybody knows hidey hole.
Sorry.
I just didn't know that we still used the word hidey hole. When we return, if you're looking for a job, I'm going to tell you where to look. And it's actually not in the public sector. It's a private sector gig, and it's an intern. You'll love it. Keep it here, everybody. This is Tony Katz Tonight.
This hour is powered by
2 minutes to your life.
Flower and Patio Show, March 8th through 16th.
Stressful things during the day can keep you awake at night. Instead of sleeping, your mind is still spinning from stress.
Unisom Twitter loves
is
your
the
hiccups.
Help you need to fall asleep. Unisom sleep tabs are a clinically proven effective OTC sleep aid. You fall asleep 33% faster by easing into your natural sleep cycle. With Unisom, you wake
in
refreshed.
In St. Louis, the first Monday, they test Unisom, out sirens?
A yes, of the month.
Restful night.
Use as directed. Active ingredient, toxilamine.
I had no idea.
Clinical study.
Yeah, it freaked me out.
And if your teeth are stained from coffee, tea, or smoking,
Montana, what natural disaster do they have?
Two shades wider teeth, and in 7 days, six shades. Even better, there's no messy strips or trays that you have to leave in your mouth for an hour. Just swab your teeth for 5 minutes, and you're done. To try Power Swabs, call 1-800-949-5103. Your bright white smile will have your friends talking about how great you look. Try it risk-free. 1-800-949-5103.
949-5103. 1-800-949-5103.
Hey there, it's Steve Simpson, and if you're like me, you have begun to bargain with Mother Nature. Kind of like, look, if you make it a great spring, I promise to take
you're up after this commercial
more often to really enjoy the outdoors. Now, if you notice, at no time do you ever say, and I promise to climb my ladder and make sure my gutters are clean. That is not high on your list of things you want to do, right? So, why do it? My friends at LeafGuard could not agree more. In fact, they have authorized me to give you Indy's only one-piece seamless gutter protection system on the market, installed on your home for only 99 cents labor. How's that for a spring promise? Here's the number to call, 623-8612. 623-8612. Tell them you want Steve's spring promise. You get the great protection of LeafGuard, guaranteed not to chip, peel, or crack, for only 99 cents labor. Go to leafguard.com now and give them a call for Steve's spring promise. Again, the number,
here we go.
623-8612.
Guys, the Timeshare Cancellation Center. Why? Because if you have a timeshare, you're wasting money. And you shouldn't waste money. It's absolute madness. Give them a call, 888-288-8107, or check them out online at givebackmytimeshare.com. Simple, simple thing to do. You tell them your problem. You tell them who you have the timeshare with. Very often, they know right away whether they can help. And if they can, they go to work. Their team of lawyers does one thing and one thing only. You've heard me say it. I'm going to keep saying it because it's true. They get you out of the timeshare. They get you out of the pain, and they save you a whole bunch of money in the process. 888-288-8107 for the Timeshare Cancellation Center. 888-288-8107. 888-288-8107. Or check them out online at givebackmytimeshare.com.
I remember the moment.
2 minutes.
I'll never forget that moment.
As long as I live.
Yeah, no, so I'm out for my run in St. Louis, and it's clear as can be, but I hear the sirens going off, and I'm freaking out because I'm like, what in the world is going on?
Went to school.
Right. I can imagine.
Several of us were working to rescue
a family.
That's
a thing.
They made it down.
And I was probably like a mile and a half away from home, so I ran faster than I've ever run.
Going, and we have.
Only to then have my husband tell me later on, oh, no, honey, they're just testing them.
Got them out. We helped a lot of people out. It felt
so he's purposely trying to hurt you?
No, he didn't know. He had just come home from lunch, and I was like, why are you so out of breath? And I was like, the sirens, we got to hide. And he's like, no, babe, we're okay.
I'm a citizen soldier in the National Guard.
You can serve part-time and be there the moment your community needs you. Learn more at NationalGuard.com.
Sponsored by the Indiana National Guard. Aired by the Indiana Broadcasters Association in this station.
A lot of doctors wear lapel pins. But there are only about 20 doctors in central Indiana who are allowed to wear one very special lapel pin. It's a pin that says that doctor has been certified by MD Anderson Cancer Network, a program of one of America's leading cancer care providers. If you or someone you know has cancer, lapel pin means
what
a lot.
What is this? No, I'm not talking
it
about commercial.
It says these Community Health Network physicians have met MD Anderson's nationally recognized standards.
That's insane.
And that their guidelines and treatment plans can be shared with community's patients right here locally. Nearly every week, certified community physicians discuss challenging cancer cases with the experts at MD Anderson. You see, it's much more than just a lapel pin. It's a beacon of hope. Visit ecommunity.com/cancercare. Exceptional care.
15 seconds.
Simply delivered. The pursuit is on.
It's not too late to get your furnace checked and keep out the cold this winter. Find an American Standard dealer near you at WIBC.com.
Austin, them keep doing your thing. Let these boys keep slipping, man.
This is Tony Katz Tonight. Follow Tony on Twitter at Tony Katz.
You're in.
What are the good days to buy airline tickets?
Don't they say it's like Tuesday or something?
All right, because I'm reminding myself that I'm gonna be in Indiana, in Indianapolis for the town hall, the personal and home safety town hall. Greg Garrison is going to host. Troy Riggs, the Indianapolis Public Safety Director, part of the panel. Guy Relford, attorney and range safety officer, a tactical firearms instructor. And Patrick Goffinet, Vice President of Field Services at Defender Direct, the sponsor there of the event. Tuesday, March 25th, 7 p.m., Fountain Square Theater. It's free. It is a free event as far as I know. Free to the public, will feature expert panels on home safety, guns, and personal safety. Guests can purchase top-of-the-line, state-of-the-art home security items at the event. If you're talking about it on Twitter, hashtag WIBC Town Hall, March 25th. There at the Fountain Square Theater, the one and only Greg Garrison going to be walking you through that. Fountain Square Theater, 1105 Prospect Street. So you can learn more from there and make sure you follow WIBC on Twitter at 93WIBC. So I'm going. So I'm like, that's right. You know, I wanted to talk about it. I'm like, all right, I'm going to go. So I'm like, yeah, let me just see. And all of a sudden, I'm like, tickets are out of control. Airline tickets are never that expensive. So I there's usually a day where it's better to buy than other days. So it's Tuesday? Is that it? Tuesday's the better day to buy?
I think. Let's...
I don't know. Chat room, hook me up here. Which is the right day to buy? Could you help me out there at TonyKatz.com? Paige is looking it up. Everybody is now on this. Let me go to Greg on line 3, if I could. Greg, welcome to Tony Katz tonight, my friend. What's up, Greg?
Hey, just first off, I wanted to comment. I appreciate your candid passion on all these subjects. It's refreshing to kind of get some news stories that you otherwise don't hear. A lot of it's maybe concealed, but
thank you.
Your show very much. And so, since I puffed you up, I'll go on to the other subject, and that is particularly tornadoes. Back in 1978, there was a simultaneous earthquake, and I think it was about a 5.9 that occurred in Indiana, while at the same time there was a widespread tornado outbreak.
There was an earthquake while there was a tornado.
That's correct.
The only thing left is to get an anal probe. That's the trifecta of disasters right there.
Oh, I have an aversion to that. I don't know.
Clearly.
But
I have an aversion to that. That's not a flat out refusal. That's like, listen, if I could not be bothered today with the anal probe, that would be best. I have a doctor's appointment at 2, you know, and then I got to get my car washed. So if you could. That's fantastic. I have an anal probe. I have an aversion. Oh, my goodness. But so it was simultaneous tornadoes and a 5.8. That'll move you. 5.8 can move the ground.
I was a kid then, and it was just it was nightmarish. It was quite frightening. But then also just one little bit of information. It's there's a weather index, and they have determined that Noblesville, Indiana, has the highest propensity for tornadoes in Indiana. So obviously, if you know, relocate here and stay away from Noblesville.
Wait, does it really? What determined that? And to get to Noblesville, don't you have to go through like Carmel or Fishers or Zionsville? Or I mean, don't you?
I think you go through Carmel to Noblesville. Fishers
a little more south and east, right?
More east, yeah.
Right.
But
how do you determine that?
Maybe historically the number of events that have occurred there. So they've just gathered information.
You know, it's interesting. You know, I lived in Tampa Bay for a few years, and the interesting thing about Tampa Bay, for all the rain and all the lightning that they get, and in the summer, about in the afternoon, mid-afternoon, there will be rain because of all the humidity that is built up. You literally think the sky has opened. It's insane for about 6.5 minutes, and then it's done. It's just done, and the humidity drops about 35%, and you can actually breathe for a little bit. But the rains are intense. But when hurricanes come to that part, because that's on the Gulf of Mexico side, it's on the west side, they go underneath Tampa Bay, or they go over. They go well to the north of Tampa Bay. They never, ever hit Tampa Bay. So there is something to be said. I find it odd to hear, but it makes sense, I guess. There are places that just have propensities and places that I'm sorry we lost them. And places that don't. I always thought that was interesting. But I appreciate the phone call and your aversion to anal probes. That has never been phrased in so eloquent a terminology. In so clearly a way. And by the way, Paige, Tuesday is the least expensive day to fly?
Yeah, the weekends are the best day to buy, and Tuesday is the cheapest day to fly.
according to USA Today.
Wait, I don't understand what that means. So I should buy on the weekend and fly on a Tuesday.
Yes.
Well, that's not going to happen. I'm going to buy on a Tuesday and fly on a weekend. Listen to my plan. Go with me on this, Paige. Go with me on this. I get myself a ticket that gets me in about 3 o'clock, 3:30 to Indianapolis, right, on a Sunday. That means there's just enough time to check in wherever it is I'm going to stay and then grab a steak. And it's a Sunday, so you would actually be available.
True.
So I could actually say, hey, we're going to go have a steak. I have now been to St. Elmo's a few times. I think their ribeye is spectacular. I need to now try something new. Prime 47 is next. Mm. Prime 47 is clearly next, and I think that is something we should do.
I'm always down for steak.
That's all I'm saying. And you can even bring the husband. Ooh. He's on his own.
He would love that. Oh my!
He has to buy his own way. I ain't doing that. I mean, he doesn't do any work here. Honestly, what has he done for the show? What has he done for the show? Exactly, my friend.
He lets me come.
No. You are a strong, independent woman. How many times do I have to keep telling you that?
I know.
Fly free. You are not being held down by a man.
No,
we're not
going to
have
me.
That kind of program. That's right, he supports you, because that's what he's supposed to do.
Oh.
That's right.
Wow.
Equal power.
Chains being released.
There are no chains here. There are no chains. You are a strong, independent, proud woman. And you will grab your wings and you will fly. Preach it, my sister.
I think you're the one preaching.
Testify!
Hallelujah!
I can do it. You want to see me fire and brimstone? Bring it. Get me some kind of
organ music
or gospel chant. A little gospel choir action. I will sing your praises about being a strong woman. Not gonna let a man keep you down, Paige. All your life, you have had men trying to control you. And when it wasn't a man, it was Katie trying to control you. Where's the music? It doesn't work without the music. I'm just a crazy person screaming into a microphone without the music, Paige.
I know.
You got to set the mood.
I'm trying to set the mood.
Oh, mood's over.
Sorry.
Do you have anything in the fridge? Basically is what just happened here. Oh, I had it, everybody. I had it for you. I'll still do it, but she hasn't found the music. I don't understand it.
It's hard to find it on YouTube, actually.
You have to start building a library. Can we talk about this?
Sure.
We can't be relying on. Sorry, everybody. We're doing this right now. You can't be relying on YouTube for stuff that we're now into using. So, for example. In a world, we know where that is. We got to clip it. We got to put it in our own.
I have it clipped.
Okay, good. That's.
But it's not. I mean, the problem is that a song is a little bit bigger, so it takes up more space.
I agree. But what's your point?
Like, my point is, I don't necessarily have the space for it.
Whoa! Why don't we have the space for it?
I guess I could just put it in News Boss.
Yeah. Why don't we have the space for it? Abdul or Garrison has space, and we don't have space. Oh hell no. The chicks get one mention on Rush Limbaugh, all of a sudden I don't have space?
They're pushing.
That is not happening. I will have new computers put in for this program. Don't ever tell me we don't have space. All right? You tell Dana Lash, I don't care how many stations there are, I need space. Tell me.
Do you want the gospel choir behind you for that?
Yeah. Oh, yes. When we come, okay, well, I'll do it on the way out. Let me hear it.
Oh, let me get it going.
Oh, that's not a no. That's too sweet. You can't
do it.
It's
what I could find quickly.
You got to find some during the break. When we come back, I will bring the truth and the light to all of you. You're welcome. This is Tony Katz Tonight.
While survival of the fittest is a commonly accepted theory, ask yourself this. Are you fit to survive winter's next assault?
Some of the coldest air we've seen.
Wind chills definitely got to be very cold.
When the temperature and the snow drops.
Very, very cold.
Turn to your most trusted ally in the battle to weather winter's worst.
It's pretty slow going. 30 miles an hour.
Temperatures are going to be well below.
On the level.
Thank you, level. Katie reference out of nowhere. That's boom. That's how we bring it. That's how it works. I am looking forward to going, though. Like, I'm not doing anything for the event. Like, there's no reason for me to be there. But I'm
dying for them to come back out and do more rooms.
The morning show was a very interesting experience. I'm just going to turn this down for a second, Paige. The morning show was an extremely interesting experience for me. And one of the things that I got to admit I really liked, I still think about it. I was very surprised how much I enjoyed doing mornings and bringing Paige back up a little bit so she can talk, so I can hear her.
Best deal ever.
And now that I know when all that was happening with there was like 7 murders in 12 hours. And I'm having this conversation about what's happening to Indianapolis. How is this all of a sudden happening? This was before we knew where the connections were. It was people who knew people and possibly gang-related and drug-related. Definitely gang-related, I should say.
If you find yourself saying that, I'm going to get strong, I'm going to take care of myself, and I'm going to do it starting right now.
You started building much quicker that connection with the city. I think that sometimes a lot of people don't understand. Is the show that I'm doing a local show? Is the show I'm doing a national show? And the answer is yes. It's... I feel a responsibility, if you will, to make sure that when some of these things are happening, I am hitting them. I am discussing them. That's where that audience is. Do I think that this show can go wide as a late night show? I absolutely do. It's never where my mind is or what I thought of, but I believe in it. I totally believe it. But the doing the mornings, which I can't describe to you what a unique experience that was and where I how I could see, like, you're like, could you imagine doing that every day? And a part of me is like, a little bit.
To Barbara's platinum certified
little bit. You know, I mean, I know guys who do it. We all know, you know, the dear Larry O'Connor there at WMAL and some other people. It's a unique kind of thing to do every single day. But I want to see some of that through. Like, I want to know what people there are thinking and where their heads are on this violence issue, on this crime issue. So when I'm talking about it here, I know exactly where people are at, so I can better relate. And it's I get that people don't think of me in that way in terms of more of a local guy, but there's something unique to, like I have this. I have the web for doing national, you know, and doing big and the writing and stuff like that. There's something very unique about that experience. I enjoyed it.
This is Tony Katz Tonight. Follow Tony on Twitter at Tony Katz.
This is not in any way gospel music.
I know. I'm having an issue finding something more upbeat for you.
That's all right. That's all right. The moment's over.
I know.
It's gone. It's gone.
I think we had this issue last time because when you... I'll just have to spend time looking for it, because when you YouTube it, they give you all really sweet stuff.
Right. Now, we got to find some praise the Lord, testify. If I'm going to do it, right? Like, if I'm going to bring the fire and brimstone.
Right.
But I don't want to hear that we don't have the space. I you know I don't accept that stuff. What are you, out of your mind?
I was thinking of my drive, but yeah, you're right. I forgot about News Boss.
So... we have all the space we want, and if we need to delete things like Limbaugh's show, fine.
We'll just get rid of it.
Whatever, you know.
Dump it.
You know, listen, I like the guy. I think he's going to make a career of this. I think he's going places. But, you know, we got to do what we got to do. I told you about a story about a German family that is being deported from the United States. And they came to the U.S. in 2008 seeking what is Todd Starnes is referring to as political asylum. They fled their German homeland in the face of religious persecution for homeschooling their children. Homeschooling is not allowed in Germany, it turns out. I didn't know that. They are very aggressive, if you will, in teaching a multiculturalism. So they were initially given asylum, but the Obama administration objected, claiming that German laws that outlaw homeschooling do not constitute persecution. They said the goal in Germany is for an open, pluralistic society. Teaching tolerance to children of all backgrounds helps to develop the ability to interact as a fully functioning citizen in Germany. And on Monday, the Supreme Court declined to hear their appeal, paving the way for the Christian family of eight to be deported. It's interesting because maybe there is a point to be made that not being able to homeschool your children doesn't necessarily mean religious persecution. But there is something to be said about the idea that there is a reason that people come here. That for all of the cases that we see, and the far too often cases that we see, of people coming to America and not respecting where they are, not loving where they are, thinking for some reason that where they came from is better than where they are now, there are people who are still see America as the place to better their lives, the place to be free, the place where they will not be persecuted, that they can do as they wish, that they can raise their families as they wish. And that's why I think the story resonates. It's over there at foxnews.com. I will go right now and I'll put it in the chat room at tonykatz.com. I think that it's an important story, and I had brought it up earlier. It was worth discussing. I'm a believer in homeschooling. I think homeschooling has a tremendous value. No, I don't think it in any way jeopardizes socialization of children, especially now when there are so many different activities happening amongst homeschooling families and homeschooling groups of families and meetups. Social media has made it so much easier in order to meet people, engage people, and utilize that. And I love the idea that why have a kid in school for 7+ hours to then come home and do X number of hours of homework and then any extracurricular activity? How in the world do you fit all that in? You can fit in a lot of that education in 3.5 hours. Then there's an opportunity to create what literally is better kids. What are you raising? You know, is your objective to raise an academic, or is your objective to raise a child into being an adult? If you've got young boys, are you trying to raise good math students, or are you trying to raise good men? That's the question. Are you trying to what's more important, that they were able to get to their class on time and did all their homework, or they know the difference between right or wrong and are willing to they can make those decisions for themselves, so you have more faith in them when they're out in that world, that when they meet up with some kind of resistance, they don't crumble, that they have resiliency? What is it that you're, what are you raising? That's where I think homeschool has a value, because I think that if you're going to teach to the test should be how you live a life, and shouldn't be whether or not you got a good grade according to Mrs. Smith. I think that sometimes you get tested, and you gotta at times pass the tests, but what is it that you're really raising? If you're telling me, well, they got to go to college, well, then you're giving me a great answer about what it is you're raising. We live in a society where they don't have to go to college. We will find that people do not hire to the degree, they hire to the skill set. That skills will matter. That you don't have to have a college degree in order to be a computer programmer. You can just know how to program and don't program computers. Program, be an app programmer. What are there, 7 jobs out there right now for every 1 programmer? Go do that. Learn how to engage those skills. Learn how to engage the skills that Mike Rowe talks about that move America. You know, those skills that people call dirty jobs and think that are beneath them, but are the extremely well-paying jobs and aren't beneath anybody who has a sense of dignity. What are you raising? You know, it's part of that. So I was going to say to you, Paige, you know, I was having this conversation with the chat room before we during the break about going to the event there, the town hall, which I'm looking forward to. I'm looking forward to March 25th, 7 p.m. I'll be there. I'll be there for a couple hours right before the show, and then we'll come back and we'll do the show. We'll talk all about it. So it's gonna be very cool that Tuesday night. I want to know what's happening in Indianapolis. It's where I do the show, and while I do a show that's much more national and in scope, I talk about things locally because it matters. It matters to me. I think it matters to the audience, and I think there are things happening that are worth conversation. And when I was there filling in for mornings, which I found to be a really unique and wonderful experience, like wonderful, I enjoyed it more than I could talk about. And there were this rash of murders, the 7 murders in 12 hours, and the other things that have been happening. I want to know where people are on those subjects. I want to know what they're thinking about. I want to know where their head's at. So when I talk about things, when things happen, I have a feel. I want to understand. I think that's the only way you can be good at this. So I will absolutely be there on March 25th. My thanks to all of you. Don't forget to follow Paige on Twitter at producer_Paige. Holly Bacon, you are loved. We are thinking about you. And all the best. Lots of thoughts are with you at HollyBacon77. Follow me at Tony Katz. Tomorrow, everyone, much, much love. Take care.
Oh, my God, Susie, is that you?
Hey, Bob.
You look so skinny.
Oh, my God.
Did you have bariatric surgery?
Susie?
No, I didn't.
Becky, look at her butt.
Thank you.
You lose all that weight.
I'll be right with you.
It is so big.
Hi, I'm Alan Smith, creator of the Bistrictin Weight Control System. And I love
guys, can't thank you enough. I appreciate you being here with the programs. And have yourselves a good night. Get some rest. Do your thing. I'll see you tomorrow, guys. Take care.